This is Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls here about whatever you want to discuss. You just dial in toll-free. The number is 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. Skype on into the show. Our username is lrn.fm, so feel free to connect in that way if you prefer. Ian and Mark in the studio with you as normal on a Tuesday night, but we've got somebody different in here on our third microphone. Johnny Ray is preparing, our normal Tuesday night co-host, Johnny Ray is preparing for a play. He's going to be in The Importance of Being Earnest, and I think they're gearing up to put that show on. So
he's earnestly pursuing that.
And I believe he is in the title role, if I'm not mistaken.
Is that Ernest?
I presume. but nonetheless, so Josie Wells, welcome to Free Talk Live.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, so you are also known affectionately as The Outlaw.
Yes,
Josie
I am.
Josie Wells.
Yes, I am.
And were you born with that name or did you choose it for yourself? Because it's also the same name as a Clint Eastwood film, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, Josie is my real first name. Mm-hmm. And I got the nickname The Outlaw when I was about 10.
From your dad?
No, from my softball coach, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so he called me that, and Josie Wells stuck for quite some
time. That's great.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yep.
So you're an activist. You love freedom. You moved to New Hampshire from Philadelphia not too long ago.
Yeah, about 3 months ago now, I guess.
What was it that, I guess, because we talk a lot about the Free State Project on Free Talk Live, and to some extent Free Talk Live is a talk show. In that it's open phones and we'll take calls from anybody about anything. But it's also kind of like a reality show in that we feature not just Ian and Mark every night, but also different people on our third microphone. Your roommate Chris Cantwell is going to be on tomorrow night, as a matter of fact. So we kind of featured different personalities in New Hampshire, some of the activist personalities here, and many of the people involved in the show are actually out in the streets doing activism. You and I, for instance, have gone out and done cop block in the college neighborhood a couple times thus far. And so, you know, kind of like to focus on some of the things that you're into. So what was it that brought you to New Hampshire?
Well, actually, I move often. I like to move around. I like to be mobile. I had talked to Adamo and Kate and Pete and all of them a couple of months ago. And I said, Adamo, when they first moved in April, they asked if I would like to move in. And I said, oh, you know, I just moved into this cabin in the woods. So I think I'm going to try that for a while. And then a couple months later, I said, oh, now it's time to move on to the next place. And I asked them and they still had a room open. So I moved there and I stayed there for a couple months.
Did I hear it's true that you've moved something like 15 times in as many years?
Like 10 years, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's got to be tough. Like for me, that's not something I'm interested in. I like to just stay in one place. I don't even like to go, like Mark's going to this trip tomorrow to what, Vegas for some sort of direct-to-consumer convention or
something? Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Is that where they sell like the as seen on TV stuff?
I mean, well, they don't sell it there. They promote it there. Uh-huh. That's their annual convention and it's good stuff.
So yeah. It is the as seen on TV convention.
Sounds
so cool.
Do you get to see the pitchman there too? Like
the pitchman.
ShamWow guy.
Yeah, yep. He was there the last time. He's really tall.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And
isn't he also the slap chop guy?
He is the slap chop guy, right.
That's awesome.
You'll love my nuts.
That's him.
That's great.
So yeah, I mean, I don't even like to leave where I currently am, but you're sort of a floater. So
yeah,
to speak.
I am. My mother's actually called me her butterfly since I was about 14. Because I would just kind of go and do my own thing and come back.
I have to say, I'm glad you're here because it's been great having you in Keene thus far. And hopefully you'll stick around for a little while.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I plan to be here for a while.
Okay, cool.
So, I like it. Yeah. So it's been a good time. I'm bracing myself for the winter. Everyone keeps telling me I'm not ready for the winters, but.
What now? So you're from Philadelphia?
Yeah. And they're not.
They have snow there, right?
Right. I don't know why everyone keeps warning me about how bad it's going to be.
I'd say it's a zone or two below New Hampshire.
It's probably a little warmer there.
Yeah, but, I mean, you know. I don't think it's that big of a deal, honestly. Yeah. The cold weather is made to be such a big deal. But if you're a city dweller...
And you are in the city here.
And by city dweller, I don't even mean a large city dweller. But if you're a city dweller, you don't deal with it that much, especially if you have a garage. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not like you're going out and scrape... You know, you go from the heated house, you run out to the car, maybe the car's been sitting in a heated garage, or you turn the heat on in the car. You then drive to work. You run through the cold parking lot into the heated work. Then you stay at the heated work until you do the opposite. It's not that big of a deal.
Yeah, it's not that bad.
Share your thoughts tonight with us. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. So I'd asked you, Josie, what's something you wanted to talk about here tonight on Free Talk Live, and you did bring up the Kent State sweatshirt or sweater issue.
Yeah, the controversy of, I think it was yesterday, that was the big controversy.
I saw on Facebook?
Yeah, I mean, all over the news. It was on the news. Not mainstream. I guess RT is the most mainstream.
I heard it on the mainstream news this morning. I think it was CBS News talking about it. They played some kind of statement, and I've actually got a statement here from Urban Outfitters. So to bring you up to speed, so my understanding of the story is that all of a sudden on the shelves at Urban Outfitters is this sweatshirt, Kent State, just sort of like college students everywhere have their college name on their sweater. So not unusual to see something like that. But what was unusual is that it appeared to be a blood-stained sweatshirt.
And yeah, it has that look to it.
Yeah.
It has bullet holes in it.
Does it have holes, too?
It has holes in it.
Okay.
And
too soon?
The explanation I'd seen for this, or that I heard for this, was ridiculous, claiming that the holes came from wear and tear or something like that, and that it wasn't blood, it was just
tie-dye-ish.
Some sort of coloring.
Sunspot. They said something with sunspot. I forget exactly what they said.
It was the lamest excuse I'd ever heard. But here's a story from Time Magazine. They wrote about the latest controversy to hit Urban Outfitters. This Kent State sweatshirt vintage that appeared to have bloodstains on it, an apparent reference to the shooting deaths of four students by National Guardsmen that took place during a May 1970 protest on the Ohio campus. I mean, this is an infamous event, but maybe it's not so infamous. Maybe the buyer at Urban Outfitters had no idea what he or she was actually looking at, and they just thought it was a cool design for a sweatshirt.
I think that Kent State is, that shooting is so wrapped up in that even people who don't know anything about what happened still associate Kent State with a shooting, and they're not sure exactly what.
I don't know. I mean, I look at some of the. I remember watching like jaywalking on Jay Leno when I was younger, and it's amazing what people just don't know and don't pay attention to.
It's true.
So I can see, especially a lot of the younger generation, just picking it up and being like, "Oh, this looks cool." But what I liked about the story coming out was that imagine how many times Kent State was Googled.
That's true. And I think that's an interesting look at this because there's a lot of outrage about this move by Urban Outfitters, and it has certainly started conversations. And people who didn't know, because certainly there are people in their 20s, for instance, or teens that have no idea what Kent State was. I don't imagine it's covered at all, if very heavily, in government school history classes. So maybe this has really unintentionally on Urban Outfitters' part has really brought the Kent State story where government troops shot students, peaceful students. And didn't it come out recently something about that there was an agent provocateur?
Yeah, as I understand it, there was an NPR report I heard, and I think it was last year, was like the 30th anniversary or something like that. And they've discovered that it was actually government agent provocateurs in the crowd that began throwing the stones that caused the National Guard to begin shooting at the students. And you know, for some reason, it doesn't seem to matter to anyone because I guess it's been so long, right? Oh, well, all the people
they
who made
do
the
that
decision,
now.
All the people who made these decisions are dead now. I guess there's nothing we can do about it. But this goes on all the time. It's not just our government. It's every government. This is what they do.
We just experienced that over the weekend in New York City at the rallies for the 9/11, the 9/11 protest and 9/11 truth.
You experienced agent provocateurs?
What seemed to be a very aggressive agent provocateur. She was screaming, really aggressively, first at the police about how the police were protecting, Bush and this and that, and why they weren't protecting us. And at first, I'm like, oh, she's just passionate, and that's fine. But anyone who would, try to get any attention, she would scream at, and, obscenities and slang. And, it was not good.
We'll come back with more here in moments, whether you want to talk about agents provocateur or the Kent State sweatshirt controversy. I've got the actual statement here from Urban Outfitters. We'll read that on the way, and you can share your thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You take control here on Free Talk Live.
Angioprim can unclog blocked arteries and improve blood flow in all parts of your body. Angioprim is oral chelation. Easy, simple, liquid oral chelation. You take it with juice before breakfast and forget about it. Angioprim works fast, unlike old-fashioned chelation that takes hours. Just log on to angioprim.com. That's Angioprim, A-N-G-I-O-P-R-I-M, angioprim.com. Angioprim users say they have more energy, more strength, more endurance. Increased circulation and blood flow will make all your body parts work better. Log on to angioprim.com to get more information on how you can get started and start feeling better, having fun, and doing more again. Lots more. Talk to a trained Angioprim consultant. Call Angioprim toll-free at 877-882-7221. That's 877-882-7221. Or log on for complete information. Angioprim.com. That's angioprim.com. Find out how Angioprim can work for you. Get the facts about Angioprim at angioprim.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc, and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. Dial toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that you will find there on the site. They're free, unlike those other talk show hosts in the business who want to charge you for their websites. We give it away, freetalklive.com. Now, if you need focus and are feeling fatigued and trying to get that extra edge when it counts, look into modafinil from modup.net. Studies show 1 in 5 students use this cognitive enhancer, offering multiple benefits, including a double-digit increase in short-term memory, fighting off fatigue, and greater focus overall so you can get things done. Businessmen around the world are talking about modafinil from modup.net and how it's making the difference in their work, giving them that critical edge they need. So, over at modup.net, they make it affordable for everyone to take advantage of the benefits of modafinil by being 80 to 85% lower in price than the brand name. But don't mistake lower prices for inferior quality. They ensure that purity and potency are consistent to that of the branded version. Remember, Free Talk Live is an international radio show, and modup.net ships worldwide. It's your responsibility to know if local prescription requirements and laws apply. You'll get a deep 33% discount if you pay with Bitcoin at modup.net, and you can also use code FTL, like Free Talk Live, to get 10 free tablets with your order. So use the code FTL at modup, modup.net. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian here.
It's Josie.
And Mark.
And you can join us at 855-450-FREE. We'd love to hear what you think about this Urban Outfitters sweatshirt controversy that is quite the topic, from what I understand. I'm hearing it on mainstream media. Time magazine here has the official statement from Urban Outfitters. You tell me if you believe them. Because apparently this isn't the first time that Urban Outfitters has been involved in some sort of clothing controversy. So here's the official statement. Quote, Urban Outfitters, and for those of you that don't know, this is about a Kent State t-shirt or a Kent State sweater that apparently was bloody or appeared bloody, had what appeared to be holes in it, perhaps bullet holes was the suggestion. And I was wrong. When I said this was appearing on store shelves, I jumped to that conclusion, figuring that's how clothing stores work. Apparently, Urban Outfitters has what they call their vintage collection. The vintage finds, and they were selling this shirt for $129, some sort of shirt that they found at a yard sale, basically, at the flea market. They found this at a flea market, so they claim, and they put it on their website. There's only one of them, so they were not appearing on store shelves. There was only one appearing on their website, and that is what caused, somebody saw it, so it got posted online and spread virally. So here's their response. Quote, Urban Outfitters would like to extend our sincerest apologies to Kent State University and the Kent State community. We're deeply saddened by the recent uproar our vintage Kent State sweatshirt has caused. Though it was never our intention to offend anyone, we understand how the item could have been perceived negatively. The tragic events that took place in 1970 are not forgotten, and our company regrets that people believe we would intentionally make light of such a horrific part of our nation's history.
I don't know, though. I mean, I don't know if this is making light, necessarily. This t-shirt is art, and it's a single piece of art. But if you mass-produced, you can mass-produce art.
Sure.
And it says whatever it says to you. You know, I mean, this could mean, I celebrate the shooting of students at Kent State. Yay! Funny, funny.
It could mean that art has all kinds of different interpretations.
Or it says, I'd like to bring to your attention the slaughter of our students by our government.
It's a conversation starter, that's for sure.
Whatever it says is what it says to the person who made it, the person who wore it, and the person who sees it. And I don't know what the, I mean, I guess that's why it's a news story, but it seems kind of funny that a single sweatshirt is making a big splash.
Well, it certainly appeared to Ian and I'm sure a lot of us that this is something that they're selling. If it's appearing on a website of a national chain, then you would assume that there's more than one. Most would. What I don't understand is how this got through, whatever necessary steps to make it onto the shelf without anyone possibly bringing up the possible implications that this sweatshirt, brings up.
Yeah, I don't know either. And well, in this case, it's not on the shelf, right? It's on the virtual shelf.
Right.
It was just their website that features this. And what I'm shocked at is that somebody might probably pay $129 for what is essentially a yard sale item, and that Urban Outfitters is able to go to a flea market, pluck some crappy, tattered old sweater off the shelves there at the flea market, and then resell it for $129 is just an amazing testimony to, I mean, I'm presuming they sell crap like this all the time. Again, they have this.
Right, that's not vintage, the only one.
This vintage finds collection, which are these supposed one-offs that they're finding out there in the world. This is a junk sweater, and so why you would have something like this is just bizarre to me. I guess tears are in.
Hipster. The hipster's band. That's in.
So, and I guess looking like you've been shot at Kent State could be in as far as hipsters
very
are concerned.
Very trendy
as
nowadays.
Well.
Halloween's coming up.
To promote such an event, they say, and they're this is continuing with their little statement, is disgraceful, insensitive, and in poor taste. To further clarify, despite what has been reported, this is a vintage item and there is only one. Once the negative feedback was brought to our attention, we removed the item immediately from sale. Urban Outfitters purchased the one-of-a-kind sweatshirt from the Rose Bowl flea market as part of our sun-faded vintage collection. There's no blood on the sweatshirt, nor did we ever promote it as such. The discoloration that has been mistaken for blood is from natural fading and sun exposure. Now, that sounds totally unbelievable. This sweater, this picture of the sweater, unless I'm expected to believe that the dark red splotch on the sweater is in point of fact the original color of the sweater and that the rest of the sweater has been sun faded away from dark, dark red to a light pink to white kind of color, I don't believe that for a moment.
I don't believe that at all.
Yeah.
It just doesn't make any sense.
Somebody made this as a piece of art, and that's what it is.
I think that's the case, but here's what my question is because usually when you have buyers, and this is going to be the lowest level of buyer, right? This is a person who goes out and combs flea markets for finds for Urban Outfitters, and they're selling this at $120, so I don't know how many pieces of clothing you can grab in an hour that make – that you can sell at $100+ to pay this person's paycheck because it's going to be a lot more than what they make. But I would think that this is a very low-level position. This is an intern starting sort of position.
Yeah, but so, the person who's going to the flea market, is that the same person who's actually listing it on their website? Surely this went through more than one pair of hands in a big company like
Really?
Urban Outfitters.
I wouldn't think so. I would think this is your job listed up here and we want us to touch as few hands as possible or whatever.
Could be.
I could be wrong, but it seems to me that when you're talking about buyers, generally you're talking about young women and clothing buyers. And
you think so?
Well, I'm just looking at the numbers,
I think in fashion, they're pretty stringent as to what they want to go with the trends, and especially Urban Outfitters because they have a very specific demographic that they're catering to, and it's the younger crowd.
Is it male
crowd,
or female?
It's male and female, but it's definitely younger. It's college age, high school college age.
Okay.
25,000, by the way, is how many employees Urban Outfitters has globally. So maybe you're right, Mark. Maybe it's just this one person who's responsible for this, but I don't think so. And I don't believe the story that it was found at a flea market either.
Well, I don't know about that.
The toll-free note, if it was found there, it was put there as a piece of art. I'm not claiming it's actual blood, but it definitely was intended to look like blood. This is not some random sun fading. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Next to water and food, you need a safe, storable fuel supply for your preparedness needs. Spare fuel is the answer. Spare fuel can be used in any gas-powered vehicle or generator. Spare fuel is perfect for any unforeseen out-of-gas emergencies. Unlike gasoline, spare fuel is safe to store with your other supplies, and it can be stored for many years. Go to GetSpareFuel.com for special pricing. That's GetSpareFuel.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Tollhouse Morsels, helping you create special moments and memories your family will cherish forever. Visit us at tollhouse.com. You may bake for birthdays and holidays, but why stop there? Sweeten up the rest of the year by designating monthly dessert days. Treat your family to one of their favorites or surprise them with something new. Either way, you'll create a tradition everyone will love. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever's on your mind. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Apparently, Barack Obama is going to be sending thousands of troops to shoot Ebola to death. We'll find out more about that here in a moment. And you can bring up whatever is on your mind. Coming up here, Mark, you're going to be actually leaving town for a few days, but not for what's really important, and that is the upcoming Bitcoin party at Walt Disney World. Coins in the Kingdom coming up in early October.
Right, that's October 4th through 6th at the Wyndham Lake Buena Vista in downtown Disney. And it's going to be a lot of fun. It's a Bitcoin party. Lots of the Bitcoin names are going to be there. Pamela Morgan from Empowered Law, Jeremy Gardner from Cryptocurrency College Network, MK Lords from Bitcoin Not Bombs, Will Pagman from Tepiki. I've never can say that name.
Tepiki. Yeah. First time I've ever seen it.
Well, it's anyway, big Bitcoin company. Anyway, Kyle Drake from Skyhook, Jeffrey Tucker from Liberty.me, Charlie Shrim, one of the early Bitcoin pioneers. Should be a lot of fun. Come hang out with us at coinsinthekingdom.com. And you know, it costs $60 for tickets. It's really, really inexpensive. Hotel rooms are only $100 a night. Kids under 12 are free at the event. Funds mandatory. Come celebrate Magic Internet Money at the Magic Kingdom. Yes, they will be going to the Magic Kingdom on the last day of the event. So the first 2 days over the weekend are the event itself, and then they're going to go to Disney. It's going to be a lot of fun. Coinsinthekingdom.com.
All right, Josie Wells is with us here tonight. Ian and Mark in the studio. Your calls welcome at 855-450-FREE. We're kind of looking at this Urban Outfitters story and actually have their official statement about this sweatshirt or the sweater that has the Kent State logo on it and also appears to be stained with blood. It also apparently appears to have holes in it. I didn't get a high-resolution version of this, the picture of the sweater, so I haven't seen the actual bullet holes in it yet. Josie, you've seen it close enough?
I have not. I have just read what other people posted about seeing the bulldoze.
So that's also what I've heard. And they're claiming that the red is not blood. They're claiming that it was natural fading and sun exposure. This sounds totally like BS to me, because if you actually look at the picture, you don't need a high resolution photo to be able to tell there's dark red splots on this thing, and it looks very much like blood. Whether or not it actually is another question. I don't suspect that it is. I think this is, as we were discussing before, a piece of artwork. And like a good piece of artwork, it is. It can be interpreted in different ways. You know, when you look at a piece of art, whether it's something that's static or it's a movie or something like that, everybody has their own preconceptions and ideas and beliefs that they bring into seeing a piece of art, and so therefore, good artwork can make people feel differently, you know, and that you may not get the same message as what the original artist was trying to intend. So maybe the artist was trying to intend, maybe the intention was to get a conversation started about Kent State and the massacre of the students there on behalf of the federal government. Maybe that was it. Or maybe the artist is somebody who just thinks it's funny to put out a bloodstained sweatshirt or ironic or something like that. I don't know what their intentions were, and Urban Outfitters certainly isn't going to identify the artist if they know who it is. Their claim is that one of their buyers for their so-called vintage collection, or the vintage finds, they claim the buyer was at some flea market, the Rose Bowl flea market, and just found it there. And then they put it up on the website asking for $129 for this thing. Let me finish up their statement here. They claim that, again, it was sun exposure and natural fading that was mistaken for blood. With all of that said, they say this truth does not excuse us from our failure to identify potential controversial products head-on. We, as a company who cater to a college-age demographic, have a responsibility to uphold to our customers. Given our history of controversial issues, we understand how our sincerity may be questioned. We can only prove our commitment to improving our product screening process through our actions and by holding ourselves accountable. Again, we sincerely apologize for this unfortunate misunderstanding and are dedicated to perfecting our internal processes to help avoid these issues in the future.
I just don't see a problem with it. It's art, and yeah, I mean, what are people need to articulate what it is that upsets them. Is it that Urban Outfitters is making money by selling, you know, something that profits off the death of these kids, or that it shows the government in a bad light? I need to know what the information is, and sort of so because I can say it. Because
or is it just upsetting that they brought this to the forefront?
I know it's difficult. At first, when I first saw it, I know what happened at Kent State. So my initial reaction was just I was sick. I was like, oh, these poor people, and you know. So that was my initial reaction, but I guess that's supposed to be your reaction when you come across or when you're reminded of such a horrific event.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, I think about it, and that's something I would do in protest or to bring, you know, to start a conversation. So
you did something involving blood, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, just a couple weeks ago. And, you know, I just poured a bucket of blood over my head, you know, to talk about
it. It was Chris Cantwell that poured it on me, right?
Yeah, it was Chris that poured the bucket, and it
he
wasn't real blood.
He seemed to really be enjoying that, by the way.
He was. And everyone kept asking me if it was real blood. No, it was not real blood. It was stage blood. But, you know, it started a conversation, and it got a lot of people talking. So it's not something that...
I thought it was a great video, by the way. Now, where could someone go to see the video of which you're speaking in case they haven't done so?
That would be the Brutalist Media TV.
Brutalist Media TV.
That's the YouTube
channel. YouTube?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's
only a couple of new videos up there.
Yeah, there's
right?
only two. It's called like a white T-shirt ice bucket challenge.
Brutalist Media TV. I thought it was great. It really, you guys were obviously using this ALS ice bucket challenge, fervor, if you will, and riffing on that. At the same time, bringing attention to a lot of different issues. There's this hard-hitting, kind of fast-cutting section in that video where you guys ask some really tough, poignant questions, and it kind of throws it in people's faces who might not have really been expecting it. It's a shocker, and I think it's in a good way.
Thanks. We had fun making it.
Yeah, and how hard was it to get the fake blood out of your hair?
Really, really hard. It took a couple showers.
Was it sugary, like a sugary kind of mix?
No, it was. I tried to do that. I came up... I, I couldn't make it in the amount that I needed, but I had to buy it. I just purchased stage blood. So it stained my hands and my feet for like a week. Yeah, but yeah, my hair, it took like a couple washings to get all of it out.
Ugh. Now, how much did you have to buy? Because it seemed like a fair amount.
It was a gallon. Was only a gallon, but it was like $30.
Where do you get it? I mean, just go online?
I just went to Party City.
Oh, really?
I just drove right
in.
That's what I asked. I thought they would probably only have, you know, one of those
little
bottles of it. But I went back and they had just buckets of it. I'm like, what are people using this for in the middle of summer in New Hampshire? This is insane.
Weird. Good stories. All right. So a little bit more about Urban Outfitters here. We finished up their statement, but Time Magazine actually, and you know, good for Time for kind of recapping this. They actually posted a brief article, which is, well, why is it that the Urban Outfitters Kent State sweatshirt is causing an uproar? For those who aren't really aware of what happened, this is their version of the story. So, it took half a century to transform Kent State from an obscure teacher's college into the second largest university in Ohio. With 21,000 students and an impressive array of modern buildings on its main campus, Time reported shortly after the shooting. But it took less than 10 terrifying seconds last week to convert the traditionally conformist campus into a bloodstained symbol of the rising student rebellion against the Nixon administration and the war in Southeast Asia. So this is way back when there was actually an anti-war movement in this country. When National Guardsmen fired indiscriminately into a crowd of unarmed civilians, killing four students, the bullets wounded the nation, wrote Time back in 1970. Now, back to today, over at Time.com, on the night of May 1st, as students at The Ohio University danced in the street, an unlucky driver attempted to get through the crowd. The mood in the country amid a wave of student protests over the Vietnam War was tense, and the confrontation over a traffic jam quickly became more serious. As students in the crowd chanted anti-war chants, the police used tear gas to get the students back to campus, but the conflict was still fresh when the administration-approved rally began the next day. A Saturday, the protests turned violent, and the local mayor requested help from the National Guard. On Sunday, Ohio Governor James Rhodes said the student protesters were, quote, the worst type of people that we harbor in America. We'll come back with more of what happened at Kent State. Your calls and thoughts are welcome if you want to reflect. Maybe you were around back then. I was not. This is Free Talk Live.
A world without breast cancer is a world with more birthdays. And by signing up for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk, you will help us get there faster. Because you're helping the American Cancer Society make the greatest impact and save more lives in more communities through groundbreaking research and access to screenings for women who need them.
Walk in Making Strides Against Breast Cancer, because you can help us finish the fight. Sign up today at MakingStridesWalk.org.
These days, when I'm in a relationship, I feel like I'm alone.
Like there's no one behind the mask. No voice on the other end of the line.
Are you looking for a car insurance policy totally devoted to you? At Geico.com, you'll find a sympathetic ear, a shoulder to cry on, butterfly kisses, and easy ways to pay your bill and manage your policy. We're waiting with bated breath to help you save money and talk about your feelings. Geico. 15 minutes could save you hundreds on car insurance.
Have you heard? Proactive Plus is faster and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway, and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin? Acne? Well, we have great news. With Proactive Plus, your acne can heal, and you can help prevent new breakouts from happening. Don't miss this limited time offer. Give us a call at 800-538-5252, because we're going to let a million people try Proactive Plus risk-free. And get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. This offer won't last long. So call Proactive Plus now and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of Proactive Plus, two free extras, and free shipping. Call 800-538-5252. This is our exclusive radio offer, never on TV. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of Proactive Plus with free shipping. That's right, free shipping. Don't wait. Call 800-538-5252. That's 800-538-5252.
Andrew Michael Jones is a liberty-loving activist and participant in the Free State Project. He's also been accused of being one of the administrators of the infamous Silk Road Anonymous Black Marketplace. Andrew is facing a federal trial for multiple crimes with no victim. Whether or not he's the Silk Road administrator named Inigo, he has not been accused of harming anyone. In fact, the Silk Road is actually an amazing advancement that has reduced the overall harm of the black market to both customers and drug sellers. Whether or not he did it, Andrew, like alleged Silk Road founder Ross Ulbricht, deserves the support of people who love liberty. Visit drewsdefense.org to learn more and contribute to his defense. You can donate via PayPal or in Bitcoin, as I did. That's drewsdefense.org. Drew's family does not have much, and his parents have put up their home and both retirement incomes to secure a $1 million bond on Andrew. He's currently on 24/7 house arrest and is prohibited from touching any device that could connect to the internet. Please contribute to his defense fund via drewsdefense.org. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you'd like. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio this evening, you've got Ian.
Josie.
And Mark.
And by the way, you can check out more of Josie the Outlaw. She's with us here tonight, but you can also get her on YouTube on the Josie Outlaw channel. Josie Outlaw is the name of the channel on YouTube, so check that out. And you're working on a new website relaunch. We'll talk about that maybe in the future.
Yeah.
All right, so cool. So we're talking about the Urban Outfitters controversy around this what appeared to be blood-spattered sweater, Kent State sweater with alleged bullet holes in it. Urban Outfitters is playing dumb. They're claiming they didn't know. Well, we didn't know. We're so sorry. We never intended to offend anybody. And, you know, maybe the intention was to offend. Maybe it wasn't. But either way, a conversation has gotten started about Kent State, and it has led Time Magazine to sort of reflect a little bit on a short recap story about what happened back in 1970 at Kent State. They're talking about the protests going on campus at Kent State. There were quite a few people involved, apparently, and they were obviously protesting the war in Vietnam and Southeast Asia, and National Guardsmen got involved and killed four students. Shot them to death. So back to the story here from Time. We'll continue that in a moment. But Mark, there's a new book you've been talking about.
Yeah, I really love it. It's called Ant Farm. And it's kind of based on Animal Farm, and it's sort of written in that style. And it's really not a very long read like Animal Farm was either. But it was praised by libertarian presidential candidate Gary Johnson. And I loved it. It took complex issues like military protection, judicial systems, currency, and dozens more, and explained how these things to average folks and even young adults could so they could easily understand how systems might work without government force and how state intervention screws everything up. If you've tried to explain some of these things to your friends about how the roads could be built by a free market, hand them a copy of Ant Farm. And if you're sick of explaining to your other friends about how the U.S. turned into a police state, hand them a copy of Ant Farm too. Stephen Aaron Gray, the author of Ant Farm, is giving away the first four chapters, and that's like half the book, to download free right at antfarmbook.com. It's antfarmbook.com. Go check them out. I think you'll love it, antfarmbook.com.
All right, so back to the story here, a little bit more from Time Magazine. This isn't really in-depth or anything like that. Obviously, you can go and do more research on this, but just sort of painting the picture of what things were like there over this particular, there's a weekend here. So there were protests on a Saturday on Kent State back in the 1970s in early May. And then they continued on through to the following Sunday when Ohio Governor James Rhodes said the student protesters were, quote, the worst type of people that we harbor in America, unquote. And despite requests to close the campus, declared a state of emergency instead when nearly 1,000 students staged a sit-in that night. It was against his order banning all protests. Mm. So some really amazing like level of activism going on.
I don't
on.
Think yeah. they were respecting his authority.
No, and good for him. Good for them. And normally this is a relatively peaceful thing. The protesters are likely very, very peaceful people. But as we discussed earlier, there's always the chance that some agent provocateur is going to get involved. And an agent provocateur is someone who works for the government. They work for the police. Or the National Guard in this case, perhaps, and they dress as though they are a protester, show up amongst the protesters, and then attempt to do things that might get the protesters in trouble or possibly gin up some violence that otherwise wouldn't have happened, get out there and start talking about violence, encouraging other people to engage in violence, therefore giving the police, or in this case the National Guard, an excuse to crush some heads.
And it may not even be an excuse. That's the assumption that that the National Guard even knew what was going on. Consider for a second that it wouldn't take too many shadowy figures to get this going, because your average National Guard guy isn't probably going to be down to just firing on some students who didn't do anything just because an agent of provocateur's involved. But if the average National Guard guy has a few rocks hit him in his upper body, he might then be ready to start shooting students, and it wouldn't matter which ones.
So about 1,000 assembled on campus on Monday. Even though classes had started again as normal, the protest was rankling students, and 1,000 of them assembled on campus, flaunting the ban and prompting the National Guard to respond with tear gas. Some students picked up the canisters and threw them back to the student demonstrators. Taunting the guardsmen was a more
serious... That's not acceptable. You're not allowed to take the tear gas canisters and throw them back at the people that threw them at you. What kind of citizen does this? You are a servile serf. You will bow before the king's men.
Delighted. Let's see. So to the student demonstrators, taunting the guardsmen was a more serious game of catch. Another excerpt from Time when they reported in 1970. Delighted spectators watching from the hilltop, windows of buildings, and the roof of another men's dorm cheered. Many demonstrators were laughing this at the throwing back of the tear gas. But then the tear gas ran out. The guardsmen retreated to the top of a hill, watching the crowd, and they fired. The protest, noisy and chaotic, stopped. 4 students were dead. William K. Schroeder, 19, had been a spectator. Sandra Lee Shure, age 20, had been walking to class. Jeffrey Glenn Miller, 20, had called his mother to let her know that he had felt he had to take part in the protests. Allison Krause, age 19, had recently placed a flower in the rifle of a guardsman at the protest. 10 others were wounded. The deaths of Kent State students inspired another wave of student protests across the country, as well as Neil Young's song, Ohio. Then they link over to the original report, actually, from May of 1970 on the Kent State shootings. I'll link to this story, and then you can dig in further on our Facebook, Google+, and Twitter. You can access all of those over at news.freetalklive.com. Let's go to the phones, and in this case to Skype, where H is on the line with us. H. Barrett, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, hello there. How are you doing?
Hey, you're on the air.
Hey, I wanted to bring up an interesting theoretical thought experiment I brought up with a statist friend of mine.
Okay,
and
sure.
I thought it was an interesting thing, but he can't seem to get his head around it. I guess, that's the way it goes sometimes. But I had this idea, if you could magically remove violence from the world and coercion from the world, that would necessitate the collapse of all the governments out there. I would surmise, right?
Well, not necessarily. I mean, because the government, as Mark discussed last night, could very well operate itself in a consensual basis if they wanted to.
But really, what they do,
just change how they operate.
But essentially, the government is an organization that protects you from violence. There's very little of role for the government other than that.
They build streets sometimes.
That's the street building organization.
Fire protection.
I'm with H. Barrett on this one. If you magically got rid of violence and coercion in the world, government would disappear.
Exactly, and that's what I was trying to say. And you know, he comes back saying things like, you know, when has the government been violent to you? And I tried to explain to him the whole idea of coercion and everything, and he just doesn't see it. I don't know how to get through to this. Like, how does this concept get conveyed properly?
Well, it's very hard to get
from. Is violent.
It is very hard for people to connect these dots, but a lot of times we'll use the example of, you know, say you're driving down the street and, you know, you see those red flashing lights go off behind you and you know you're not doing anything wrong. You know you were doing the speed limit and you just decide that you're not going to be pulled over and you're going to continue on your way and you decide not to pull over. Well, what's going to happen next? You know, a high-speed car chase is what's going to happen next, or a slow-speed car chase, or you're going to be surrounded by agents of the state who are going to surround you in your cars, get you to stop your vehicle, and they're going to come
out. Yeah, Josie, that's what you get. Yeah, that's what you get for not pulling over.
That's what you get when you deal with a bunch of violent maniacs. What other people wouldn't do that? I mean, this is really the question. Like, yes, people are going to say that because you're going to say that. You're going to come up with whatever scenario where you contact the government. Mm-hmm. They're going to say that. But look, folks, that's what they do. Yes, you acquiesce to the government right away because they are a bunch of violent freaks. You wouldn't pull over for just anybody. Somebody comes up behind you honking their horn and flashing their lights. You're not going to pull over for them. You might slow down so they can go around, or you might be dealing with them in a different fashion, but you're not going to pull over for them because you wouldn't do that.
That's the point. I mean, that's how a lot of times how I'll describe it to people, and usually they won't get it right away. You see that you know, that wall go up. But it does get through to some people, and not right away, but definitely later it sinks in.
That's absolutely true. This stuff takes time. Now, did you say this was a friend of yours, H, that you were talking to?
Yeah, he's a friend of mine.
Longtime friend? You guys go back for a while? Or?
Oh, not really. Okay. You know, like a few years. We have children that play together, and we live in the same community. But I just thought it was really interesting that the idea of removing, like, just hypothetically, of course, removing violence and coercion from the world, like, that sounds like a utopia, right? Like, this wonderful thing.
Yes.
And
yes, it does.
If you pose that to somebody who is really all about the state, they have to, at some point, necessarily acknowledge that the state would not be able to function anymore.
I don't know if that's necessarily true. I want to continue this discussion. Stand by. We'll bring you back here in moments more with Free Talk Live coming up after the news.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,237, silver opened at $18.68, while Bitcoin is trading around $470.97. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Well, Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free Script ASIC miner. Visit SovereignMiners.com to buy your miner today. And support for Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, President Barack Obama today is expected to announce a plan to send 3,000 U.S. military personnel to Africa to help with Ebola relief efforts. McClatchy reports that White House officials confirm President Obama's plan to launch a command center in Monrovia, Liberia, with 17 new Ebola treatment centers and the military personnel to help train healthcare workers. The plan also calls for the U.S. to provide sanitation kits to 400,000 households in Liberia. On Monday, Attorney General Eric Holder announced a strategy to disrupt homegrown terrorists from traveling to Syria and Iraq to join anti-American terror groups such as the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. Holder said the Department of Justice was partnering with the White House, the FBI, the Department of Homeland Security, and the National Counterterrorism Center to work with local community and religious leaders to help identify those who may join jihadist movements. As early as tomorrow, the U.S. House will vote on a resolution to approve President Obama's plan to arm and train Syrian rebels in an effort to stem the growth of the Islamic State. The resolution is expected to pass with bipartisan support. The language in the bill states that ground troops are not allowed and requires the Pentagon to report to Congress 15 days before the operation begins. Critics of the program fear the repercussions of the United States once again arming militant groups to fight off enemies. President Obama has taken much heat throughout his presidency for arming groups such as Al-Qaeda that the United States has labeled as terrorists. Support for Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, all-natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole. That's MyMagicMud.com. And today's edition of the Liberty Beat is also brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM, located in Austin, Texas, at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online, BraveNewBookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. The Miami Herald is reporting that a nurse who recently refused to participate in force-feeding Guantanamo detainees involved in a hunger strike will not face a court-martial. Navy Captain Maureen Pennington stated that he reviewed the investigation into the nurse and recommended that an administrative review take place to decide whether the official should be allowed to continue his Navy career. The decision to pursue an administrative review, as opposed to a court-martial, will allow the military to keep the details private. The nurse is a Navy lieutenant whose identity is currently unknown to the public. He apparently became a conscientious objector shortly before July 4th and refused to continue force-feeding detainees. NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden could possibly visit Switzerland in exchange for helping the Swiss government investigate U.S. spying on the nation. On Monday, the Swiss public prosecutor released a three-page document to Reuters detailing possibilities for a future visit by Snowden. The documents state if Snowden were to strike a deal with the Swiss government, he would be assured of free movement and would not be extradited. The documents are purely hypothetical, as Snowden has not been officially invited and was recently granted a three-year asylum in Russia. The Obama administration has responded to a petition on the White House website calling for body cameras to be worn by police officers around the nation. Roy Austin, a White House advisor on justice and urban affairs issues, said the technology was supported by the administration and the Department of Justice. Austin said cameras alone will not solve mistrust between the police and communities. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Now accepting Bitcoin online, rrbi.co, or by phone, 800-874-9760. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting.
Zoo visitors watch the mating rituals of the ice cream shop staff, and a serious coworker puts on headphones to focus on his sandwich. Happiness is perpetually fleeting, so try to savor the next few minutes before it disappears once again. This is the Onion Week in Review. FBI officials announced they just can't bring themselves to bust a man who recently downloaded every season of the 1990s television show Picket Fences from a BitTorrent website. While stressing that pirating copyrighted material is strictly illegal, federal authorities expressed their sympathy for the man and claimed that perhaps the story of Sheriff Jimmy Brock and the strange events in a small Wisconsin town is all he has left to cling to.
We have more than enough evidence to bust him for piracy, but if the poor guy really wants to watch all four seasons of a 20-year-old CBS drama that nobody remembers, he's clearly going through a pretty big rough patch right now. Frankly, we don't need to make it any worse.
For statistical purposes, we have seized all private data from your personal computer, and we are disgusted with your recent internet search history. You sick f***. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of the airwaves. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show here. Username is lrn.fm. Joining you in studio, Ian here.
Josie.
And Mark.
Josie the Outlaw is with us here tonight. You can check more of her out on her YouTube channel, which is called Josie Outlaw. You're also doing the new Brutalist YouTube channel as well.
Yes.
What's it called? What's that one called?
I think it's Brutalist Media TV. Brutalist. Or Brutalist Media Productions. Oh, that's what it
okay,
is.
Okay, Brutalist Media Productions.
Yes, and that is a collaboration with Chris Cantwell and I.
Great. And so far, it's been good. I've been enjoying what you guys have put out. So hopefully we'll see more soon.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Excellent. So we're going to go right back into your calls and thoughts. We were, for those of you just tuning in the middle of discussing with H. Barrett via Skype. He had called in regarding a conversation with a friend. This friend is not somebody he's known forever, but somebody that he and his children play with together, that kind of relationship. Having a conversation, the idea was, well, how to best communicate the violence that is inherent in the system to people who, you know, it's tough. It's a really challenging thing to do because so many people, even if you do point out the so-called gun in the room, or as you guys were giving the example earlier of, you know, when you're driving, if the police come up behind you and they put on their lights, what happens if you don't pull over? And then you can pretty easily see the escalation that will occur because most people have seen cops or some other sort of police chase thing on television. They're familiar with what tends to happen with someone who doesn't pull over. But it doesn't really matter sometimes when you give that example because they'll just give the excuse of, well, of course that's going to happen to you. Duh. I mean, like, they totally accepted that as a part of the idea would be to, like, this is the price they have to pay to live in civilized society. So, of course, you have to stop when the police pull you over. But, Josie, you were saying that it's not something that's going to work instantly. It's just something that has to sink in over time.
Oh, absolutely. I've found it in all aspects of my own life, my own personal life experience. There are people who are already, you know, pretty much, you know, almost there, awake, and it's still that last, those last grasp, you know, their faith in the state. There's just a little bit left that'll take a while. But I found when it comes to family and friends especially, I'm more like to lead by example rather than really push the issue. If it comes up, I'll speak my opinion without, you know, being combative and then just kind of let it sink in.
That's, I think, is the best way to do things. If you, the pushier you are, the more likely somebody's going to put up those walls and not really be interested in what you have to say. But if they come to you and ask you a question about, well, what do you think about this, then that's a good time to communicate it. And so it might be just an appropriate point to make your point and then let it drop, right? And then just kind of leave it alone for a while and see what happens over time. Because you never know what that individual is going to have happen in their life. But between now and the next time you talk or the subject is broached, it may be 6 months. But within that 6 month time frame, maybe their brother will get arrested for marijuana possession, or something else will happen where the police will misbehave and make it really crystal clear that things aren't as they expected them to be. But H. Barrett, you're still with us. Further thoughts?
Yeah, well, I was just going to say that, you know, he tends to, you know, obviously side with the state on you know, social issues. He's a more of a liberal person. But it's interesting because he shares these beliefs that corporations are really the bad thing out there. Mm. And that, you know, the state is trying to protect you from them. And how he actually uses a term. He said, you know, he would rather vote for somebody in the government rather than be indebted to somebody, meaning like indebted to a bank or something, I suppose.
I don't understand that statement. He would rather vote for...
Well, that's just, it's fear-mongering. I mean, you're not going to get him to explain it. He doesn't, you know, H. Barrett doesn't know what it means because it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, it's crazy.
You're not indebted to these corporations that you didn't sign any paperwork with. Yeah, you're indebted.
Or if I am, I'm willing to be, you know?
What
I
do you mean?
If I was indebted to a corporation, it's probably because I signed a dotted line somewhere.
Well, yeah, that would be a voluntary situation. Exactly. And, I mean, yeah, the thing that I always say to folks like that, but the government is a corporation.
Yeah.
And the government,
where do you think it came
in
from?
In the course of 9,000 years of the state, has the rich not controlled the government?
Right.
I mean, there's been no time. If you're a liberal, you should want... I mean, the government created corporations.
Right.
If you think corporations the problem, the corporations have all the money in the world to fix the government. You'll never get anything out of – there's no forward momentum in the direction they want to go.
H. Barrett.
Yeah, it's a corporation that has a special ability of with the monopoly on violence, of course. So it has that advantage over other corporations.
The corporations that it makes corporations
of. It's the spawn. It's the spawning corporation, the creator of all corporations, and they're all terrible. I mean, so it's easy to actually agree with a lefty on this, right? So when the lefties are talking about how bad corporations are, you can just totally be like, yes, you're absolutely right. Many of these corporations are abusive and they're, you know, not great companies. They've got problems, no doubt about it. But the government is a corporation, and not only that, they protect the corporations. So, in fact, that's the whole point of a corporation in a lot of ways, is protection from liability in a number of different corporate structures. And so corporations are ways for rich, wealthy people who know how to work the system to work the system to gain more wealth from the system. And they work hand in hand with the government, because if it weren't for the government's monopoly on violence and their ability and their willingness to do the bidding for these corporations, then the corporations wouldn't be near as powerful as they otherwise would be without this gigantic state.
Right. Around. If the governments couldn't control the if the corporations couldn't control the government, they would have to provide goods and services to people who want them to make money.
And that would be
Isn't that horrifying? Yeah.
Good call tonight, H. Barrett. Thanks. Let us know in the future how your conversations go. And it is a long-term project. Helping to open people's minds, to change people's minds. Destroying ideas is not a pretty process. I mean, that's ultimately what Free Talk Live is. It's an iconoclastic radio show. We were talking about the Pledge of Allegiance the other night and how terrible that is, and the flag, and, you know, just kind of attacking all these sacred cows, so to speak, and breaking them down, tearing them to bits. And that can be a disturbing process, especially for somebody that's bumbling into the show for the first time, getting in a rental car for the first time in whatever market we're on the air in, turning the car on and hearing this kind of talk on the radio. It's going to be a shock to the system.
No change occurs in one conversation. It just doesn't happen. I mean,
how brilliant your point might be.
Right. Yeah. People need, you know, they get the spark of the good idea or whatever it might be. And maybe, you know, maybe the thing you said was the good idea and maybe it wasn't. But you'll either have to chip away. But even if you're successful, they still need the continued reinforcement of the ideas. Otherwise, you know, we're going to 99.99% of people they speak to think that the government is the solution to the next problem that's presented.
Yeah, I think it's really important to know how to market your message to who you're speaking with as well. you know, when it comes to family and friends, I know that, you know, if I'm going to push it with them, I'm going to hurt those relationships and we're going to end up fighting. With people who are, you know, coworkers, I just kind of, I know with them, I just be lighthearted on my, you know, on myself, but I still drop in those little bombs from every now and again. When it's my YouTube videos, it's no holds barred because I don't have access to these people on a daily basis.
Right.
So I'm just bombarding them with all this information.
That's an interesting juxtaposition on how you approach things differently with different audiences. Like, that's the same thing with Free Talk Live. When we're on the air, we can't approach things in the same way as we would if we were in a group of people that we're constantly with, even though right. we constantly have certain level of audience out there, and some people are more fans of the show than not. But you don't know who those people are.
And you don't have to gauge how they're reacting to what you're saying.
Right, so and they're all in a different position, too.
Right.
Like, each person listening is right now in a different place about their ideas on freedom, and
yep.
you know, so we can't adjust based on that. We just have to get the ideas out principally. But that it's different from how I approached it, for instance, when I was in jail.
Yep.
I took the approach you were talking about. I kind of just did my own thing, and, you know, created relationships with the people that were in there, and then eventually I got asked questions. And then at that point, you know, well, what do you think about this? Oh, well, then that's your opportunity to explain yourself. But still, to be careful to not kind of puke on someone.
Right.
Don't be a used car salesman.
Or...
Yeah. Don't be too pushy, and also make sure that, you know, the other person is talking too. So as Mark was saying last night, ask questions
of
the person you're talking to. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We will continue with your calls and thoughts. You can bring up whatever's on your mind. Take control of the airwaves here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. And you can join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. This is Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Bellawood Flooring has changed its finishing process. So for the first time ever, Lumber Liquidators is clearing out their current stock of Bellawood at unbelievable prices. Get Bellawood Red Oak Solid pre-finished hardwood for an incredible $2.99 per square foot. That's over 30% off already low prices. Even stunning solid Bellawood Bolivian Rosewood for an amazing 51% off. These are not seconds. This is first quality with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. Special 18-month financing is available. But hurry, these clearance deals end Tuesday.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, September 15th, 2014, gold opened at $12.35.10. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $12.80.39, $6.40.20 for a half ounce, or $3.20.10 for a quarter ounce. That's $12.80.39, $6.40.20, and $3.20.10.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Everyone in Pennington is talking about it. Something smells like weed in that back part of the library. Head librarian Cookie Stevens and library volunteers Margaret Mosier and Gail Fredericks were in the middle of discussing the upcoming used book saleganza when they smelled something strange.
So Gail smelled marijuana somewhere, and we're like shocked.
Yeah.
And so Doug goes, "Do you smell it?"
Without any way to confirm that the smell was indeed weed, Cookie Stevens called her husband, Sheriff Stevens, who called in local ceramics teacher Dutch Gibbs, who lived in Seattle for a few months in the 70s.
Yeah, that's weed.
Sheriff Stevens has begun compiling a list of potential suspects, including that boy Lance, who has girl hair and hangs out down by the quarry, Greg Fromke, who was spotted this evening really going to town on some potato skins at Steaky Jake's Steakhouse, and Mr. Thompson. Luckily, one young reading enthusiast seemed unperturbed by the illicit smell.
Yeah, I don't smell anything. I really, really, really love the library.
The weed smell comes on the heels of last month's discovery of a gigantic pair of women's underpants in the children's fiction section. According to Stevens, that case remains open as well.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls here toll-free. Dial in at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com and get some free coffee while you're at it.
That's right. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com and get a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica beans. And this is really important when you think about the organic certification on coffee. You know, maybe the organic certification doesn't matter for to you on other crops, but coffee is one of the more absorbent crops in the world, right up there with tobacco, as I understand it. And coffee is grown in countries where they don't have any rules on leaded gas in many cases. Their rules on pesticides are entirely different. You don't know how that coffee was produced and washed and that kind of thing. Oftentimes you're buying coffee from the store that's ground up already. You don't have any clue. You put it right from the package into the coffee maker. That's why it's important to me. And you can go get a free pound at coffee.freetalklive.com. And you can support us because we've teamed up with Kiva in order to give microloans to people around the world. And we're giving a portion of the, purchase sale price there to give microloans to people. And we've already managed to help people around the world in Armenia, in Gaza, in Uganda, in Peru, and we're hoping to help a lot more. Please, go get your coffee at coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, let's continue with your calls and thoughts. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We've got Jason in Utah. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Josie, and Mark.
Hello?
Hi, Jason. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi. I've listened to your show a few times, but I cannot just understand why you believe that everything that government does is inherently wrong and bad for this country.
Oh, I don't think I've ever said that. I mean, I support having roads and I support having fire protection and
yeah,
I support
but the monopoly on evil that you're talking about. What is that?
Well,
monopoly on evil? Well, I don't know what that means either. I didn't say that either.
Monopoly, the government has a monopoly claims for itself a monopoly privilege on the use of violence in a given landmass. You'd agree with that statement, right?
Never.
You do not claim that the government claims a monopoly privilege on the use of violence in the United States?
Well, it's a use of initiatory force, not necessarily violence, right? Because you could use violence in defense of yourself, and that would be
legitimate. Yeah, but the government could decide at any point that that violence that you used was acceptable or unacceptable.
Mm-hmm.
No one gets to decide whether or not the government.
We have laws that protect ourselves, though.
Whose laws protect you?
Yes.
From what?
That is what the Constitution was not written against us. It was written for us to protect us from the government.
How's that working out?
Oh, okay, you're able to speak freely right now. Your opinion against the
absolutely. I will not dispute with you that in the United States of America, both you and I have the right to complain. Now, how has the Constitution, how else has it protected your freedoms? You're currently slipping down the chart of freest countries on the earth. How's that feel?
Yes, but we can, and that is no way. That shows the freedom that we have to change our government, the ability to move it in the way that we believe. Right now, it's moving in a way that is wrong, yes, But that does not make the Constitution inherently bad.
Oh, I didn't claim the Constitution's inherently bad. I would say skin cancer is better than lymph node cancer, right? But I wouldn't, the Constitution claims for itself. The claim is that it is a document that claims for itself power over other people, right? It wasn't signed by you or I.
No, but us being born into the nation, we have the rights and privileges associated with it, and that should be considered a blessing to us.
Do you know that every single one of the Bill of Rights has been compromised? That the Supreme Court considers your rights to be attenuable?
Does the Supreme Court overrun its rights? Yes. But with us in the power,
who is
we
us?
Have the chance to change that.
Us in the power?
Us as American citizens.
If you could get the other American citizens to do what you want, that might be true. However, many of them are looking for what they can get out of the government, right?
Yes, that is completely true.
Okay, so you say the government's corrupt, the government's messed up, but somehow we're wrong.
No, you're wrong because you're claiming that the way is to overbound the government. What we need to do is motivate the people together to change the government.
What is overbound? Just real quick, can you explain what you mean when you said you keep putting words in our mouths, and I don't think they're very accurate. You said something about overbound the government. What do you mean by that?
Okay, you believe that the Supreme Court oversteps its bounds, correct?
Sounds about right.
Okay, this is a better example. The Silk Road person that you defend all the time. You believe that he was wrongly imprisoned, correct?
Well, he's not exactly imprisoned. He's waiting trial. And consider that, in this country, many times when you're arrested, you never get an opportunity to get out on bond, even though you have not yet been convicted guilty by a jury of your peers.
There's more than one person involved with this, allegedly involved with the Silk Road. Ross Ulbricht, his website, freeross.org. Andrew Michael Jones, his website, drewsdefense.org. And then there's a couple of other guys, Gary, I forget his last name, and then another fourth gentleman who's, I apologize, I don't know his name. But there were four people arrested, and they're all facing life in prison. None of them have harmed anyone else. What was the point you were making about the Silk Road?
Okay, four of those people, they broke a law, correct? You don't believe so.
You don't know if they broke a law. In this country, you're innocent until proven guilty,
right?
They're
accused of conspiracy, which is not actually a crime.
They were arrested for believing they broke a law.
Oh, what? Now you believe that whenever the cops arrest somebody, they're guilty. You, my friend, are a crappy American.
Oh, my gosh. You're the one complaining about the Pledge of Allegiance in this great country that you live in with the freedom to say your rights.
You think the police are right when every single time they arrest someone. You don't believe that somebody's innocent. That's what you said. You said they were guilty because they were arrested.
I never said they were guilty. I said the cops arrested them because they believe they committed a crime. That is what I said.
Okay. All right. So they believe it.
Thanks for clarifying that. Go on.
Okay. Because they believe it, and you believe that it was wrong. So you want to overbound the government saying you can't do that because I don't believe that should be against the law. That's what you're claiming in that situation.
Well, here's what I would claim in that situation. The Constitution required an amendment to make alcohol illegal, but somehow the federal government found it within their power to make other substances illegal without an amendment to the Constitution. So therefore, what I would claim at that point is somewhere along the line, there was a real problem with how these things were made illegal in the first place. I see nothing in the document known as the Constitution of the United States of America that gives the U.S. Congress the right to make any substance illegal. Are you a strict... what's that, sir?
No, go on.
They don't have the power. They've overstepped their power. Any police officer that enforces that power, in my opinion, is guilty of treason. Every politician that was responsible for passing any laws like that is guilty of treason. These people should be get the commensurate punishments under the document that they're sworn to protect.
But these laws were passed. We gave Congress the right to pass laws.
Yes, but we gave the Congress.
I've never given anyone anything.
First, before you go, look, read the Constitution, specifically the 10th Amendment. Then call back because we didn't give them the right to pass those laws.
I don't know about you, but I wasn't even around.
That's what they're there for.
Thanks for the call, Jason.
No, it isn't. Read the document.
Thanks for the call. I didn't give anybody any power. I wasn't around, nor would I
consent if I was. The document doesn't give them the power.
We're coming up. Free Talk Live.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to infidelbodyarmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
How many good people procrastinate? When was the last time you updated your last will and testament, your living will, and your health care power of attorney? If you could get these documents included with your Legal Shield membership for no additional charge, wouldn't it just make sense to have the peace of mind of owning a Legal Shield membership? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free talk live, you can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features there. We've got a lot of features on the site, and we give them all away to you. Now, if you enjoy the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, then shop with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. You can enter into Amazon, Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You click into the right Amazon for you, get your shopping taken care of, the same great deals, same huge selection, all the reviews, everything you're used to. You're just entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a cut of the purchase. So again, go to shop.freetalklive.com. So we're going to continue here with your calls in a moment, but I felt like the last guy's call deserved a little bit more attention. He was calling to express concern for the claim out of the gate was that, you know, that we hate everything that the government does. And that's not true. I don't feel that way at all. I think there are some things that they do that would absolutely be in demand in the absence of their coercive monopoly. Now, I think that roads, certainly, the government's not so great at making roads, but, you know, every now and then they can repave a road and it'll be nice for a short while until the weather up here in New England, the frost heaves will really F things up.
We don't know how good the government's roads are because we don't get to compare them very often.
True.
To private market. Yeah, to private market roads. There is some competition. There are lots of private roads in Southern California specifically.
What about Disney World?
Disney World full of private roads. But
private like not residencies, but like neighborhoods, for instance, also frequently have private roads.
But it's hard to find the innovation because there's not real competition.
Well, most of the market is sucked up by government building projects.
Indeed. And whether you like the roads or not, you have to pay for them. So, for instance, I live in a town, the town I live in, I live on a state road. Well, the state roads pay for by gas taxes. The town roads are paid for by property taxes. Mm-hmm. I almost never use the town roads unless I am going to town hall or the fire station for town business or fire business. I am a volunteer firefighter. Mm-hmm. So why then would I have? Should I pay for the town's roads?
What do you think, Josie? Are there some things that the government does today besides roads and maybe fire protection that might actually be valuable in the absence of a coercive monopoly?
I think there are a lot of services that would be valuable, but I think, again, I get so frustrated because I think they would be done so much better in a free market. So
schools, for instance?
Schools, I can't. The thought of the way schools are today makes me sick. So I can't even think, schools aren't even a positive thing to me right now.
Did you go to government school?
I did. Well, no, I went to private school, but it's Catholic school, so that's pretty impressive. Yeah, in and of itself. But I see the schools today, I don't see them as a positive thing now. I see homeschooling and a lot of the alternative schooling as much better options. And, you know, in the schools, the kids are really not even allowed to be creative. They're not allowed to be themselves. They're restricted. They're kept inside. They're fed crappy food. It's not the way children should be treated. It's not in any way nurturing their growth. And so, yeah, I think everything would be done better without, I can say comfortably everything would be done better without government.
It doesn't mean that that I don't like the people involved either, right? Like there's individuals who work for the government who I find very likable here in Keene, New Hampshire, where we live. This is a small place, you know, unlike large cities.
My wife used to work for the state of Florida.
Yeah. You're from Philadelphia. That's a tough place to get connected with the government workers because there's probably thousands upon thousands of them.
Yeah, I've never had a good experience with any of them.
But here in Keene, these are the same people you're going to see over and over and over again, and it's easy to create a human sort of relationship with these people, even while at the same time they're using coercive threats against you. So it's kind of a bizarre dual world, and it can be very strange at times.
Well, you notice how the caller did not want to say that the government has a monopoly privilege on the use of violence in a given landmass. Mm. And the fact that they give license to you to defend yourself doesn't really have anything to do with that because they'll decide afterwards whether you defended yourself properly, whether you did it within the bounds of the law or outside of the bounds of the law. If they decide you may not defend yourself with a law's rocket, you may not. If they decide you may not defend yourself with a revolver, you may not. If they decide you may not defend yourself without retreating to the farthest corner of your house, you may not. Like, that's because They have a monopoly privilege on the use of violence, initiatory force.
Okay.
Every time violence is employed, they decide.
You persuaded me.
They decide whether a spit in the face is assault. They decide whether a water balloon is a deadly missile. Mm-hmm. They decide everything. And if you think for a moment that you're free in this area, to consider that you're not.
Well, we even have audio of Barack Obama admitting that the government's a monopoly on violence.
I don't have it
with me right now, but we've had that audio. It's not hard to find that audio.
Yeah, I can pull it right up on the internet. Is all you have to do is look up on YouTube, Barack Obama, government, nation state, monopoly, privilege, and the use of violence or something.
Yeah, so I don't hate the people involved in the state. I just think they're wrong, and what they're doing is immoral. And I get in trouble when I point that out. We were talking last night, and I didn't get a chance to play the audio from it about the video of the parking enforcement agent where I was sort of dogging her, following her. She kept turning around, doing 180-degree pivots and walking in a straight line back and forth for multiple minutes. She did it 18 times in a 2-minute time frame, and I found that funny and found it ridiculous, and I thought other people would as well, so I put it out there. But, you know, I get hate over that because it seems like I'm being mean to this woman, that, oh, well, I'm the one who's the problem, whereas people don't see her as the problem. Now, some people do. Plenty of people know that parking enforcers are not nice people in a lot of cases, and what they're doing is not nice when they put tickets on people's cars. Those are threats. If you don't respond to the threat, your car will eventually be taken from you.
Right. Yeah.
And that's just the reality of it. But right. Some people, whether they don't care about whether you think
the government has the right to ticket a car on their street or not, that's really beyond that. That's beside the point. You won't claim that they don't do something different. I mean, private companies don't do this.
No, I mean, in Philadelphia, it's even worse. They won't even, you know, sometimes they won't even ticket your car. They'll just tow it. It's a very serious problem in Philadelphia.
The government guy as well?
Yeah, they hire private companies to do it, but they're employed by the government. I mean, it's so bad that the show Parking Wars started in Philadelphia.
Philly.
I mean, it's really excessive. It's, you know, Keene, it's still not okay. It's not as bad. It's a $5 ticket and they just throw it on your car.
But they'll add up and
absolutely.
Then they'll take your car.
Exactly.
Eventually.
And it's ridiculous. Just because it's not as offensive immediately doesn't mean it's not as bad.
Well, right. But when you explain to people, and if you go to the Free Keene Facebook page, there was a post there, a couple posts where people were going off, or actually, no, it might have been Robin Hood of Keene. I apologize. The Robin Hood of Keene Facebook page. I've been going back and forth with a couple of the local haters over the past 2 days. And people they're not even close to the paradigm that we would like them to be. And again, some people are, some people aren't. Everybody's on their own path. But when I explain that, you know, the parking enforcement ultimately is a threat of violence, it's extortion based on the threat of stealing people's cars, they just deny it. I mean, and they just act as though that's okay and completely acceptable. Like they might acknowledge that goes on, but that it's completely acceptable because, hey, you parked in the space, buddy. It doesn't matter. The idea that the space is illegitimately held, that it was garnered through threat of violence, through the violence of the state, doesn't matter. None of that speaks to them because they truly believe in the system. I mean, one of these guys, when you click on his Facebook profile, he's got a picture of a U.S. flag as his cover photo.
Shocker.
So there's just some people who are not good prospects for the ideas of freedom, at least not in this time in their life. And in point of fact, they're not going to move in any direction towards you. They're going to move away from you because they see you as a threat to everything they've always known. You're a threat to the system.
And it's very frustrating to me because they'll wave that flag and cry freedom, but then won't let us fight back to be free in our own way. If they want to have a gun held to their head over a $5 parking ticket, they can.
Well, Josie, they've said we're free in Keene.
I know. I've seen what they said. But the thing is, you know, I'm not as free as I'd like to be here. You're not as free as you'd like to be here. None of us are. So why don't you let us fight and you stay in your cocoon, be happy. If you want to live that way, that's fine. But let us fight and stop this.
Well, they'll never just stop. They're going to always, right to the very bitter end, there will be people who are on the side of the state.
Absolutely.
That's how it's always going to be. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can share your thoughts. There's more coming up. Plenty of time for you with your calls. It's Free Talk Live.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
My name's Bruno. I'm 52 years old. I've tried different protein powders over the years, and they've all tasted pretty bad. I tried One World Whey and found it to be delicious. After 10 weeks on One World Whey, my wife commented, "You have more muscles and you're leaner than when you were 20 years old. My body has changed dramatically." I'm a cyclist. Normally, I'll ride 2 days on and take 2 days off. After being on One World Whey, I rode 10 days in a row in over 100-degree heat, and then I take another 2 servings of One World Whey, and then work out at the gym for another hour and a half. I just couldn't believe these results. My normal muscle tightness and soreness after working out are virtually gone. Don't take my word for it. One World Whey comes in single serving. Just give it a try.
One World Whey is derived from Amish grass-pastured cows and is newly reformulated to be higher in protein. Call 888-988-3325. That's 888-988-3325. Or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadadi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls about whatever you want to discuss. You just dial in toll-free. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features there. You get to actually create the content. Submit different things to the website. So maybe it's a YouTube video, blog post, news item. You submit the content. Other listeners can vote it up or vote it down. You get to vote on things as well. Go there. Get interactive over at freetalklive.com. Joining you in the studio, it's Ian here.
Josie.
And Mark.
And we'll continue with your calls and thoughts. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Pete is on the line in California. Pete, you're on the air.
Okay, first, I've asked 3 items. I don't generally agree with the left, but tonight you're spot on. Everything you said in the last hour and something I agree to. The caller you just
Am
got,
I the left?
He was off base. You know, I really think that you were correct on most of the things.
What makes you say that, just curious, Pete, what makes you say that we're the left?
Well, you're liberal. I agree with you about the free market and stuff, but you're generally libertarian, you know?
Well, that's the term. Libertarians are socially liberal and fiscally conservative is the way that they're often described.
Yeah. Correct. You know, I agree with most of your stuff. I don't agree with some of the
It's funny, though, that like, a lot of people on the left will describe libertarians as on the right, yeah. which, of course, is also inaccurate.
And also, when it comes to my social...
The NSA hates Tea Party guys like me, and they hate libertarians like you because we object to their corruption and coercive control. That's why both of us are on the radar. Okay, the first point I'd like to make is, you know how you're talking about provocateurs?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what you need to do? When you see one of those jokers, you need to tackle them. I mean, how much...
Are you crazy?
That's exactly what they want you to do. I've been actually dealing with this since I was 4 years old, and there's a very specific way you deal with them, and you draw attention away from them. You don't feed them attention. You kind of do everything you can to take attention away from them and reduce the possibility for violence.
One of my favorite moves, Josie, was, and I forget where I saw, I think it was actually at the 420 celebration, somebody made a sign that said cop with an arrow pointing down and then walked behind the agent or the suspected agent with the sign.
That's hysterical.
Go ahead, Pete.
But you need to tackle them and you need to put them.
See, this is why I think you may actually be an agent provocateur, Pete, because you've called the show. We've called you Pugnacious, Pete, in the past because you're constantly advocating for violence when you call
Absolutely.
Into this radio program.
You said it yourself. Self defense is.
No, that's not self-defense. It's not self-defense. For listeners just tuning in, you're talking about agents provocateur. We had discussed this earlier when we were discussing Kent State and other protests. Tell you what, Pete, I'm going to put you on hold here in a moment. Because he just keeps yammering. Anyway, so we were talking about agents provocateur. These are usually people working for the state who are place themselves among a crowd in a protest, and they will they'll do their best to gin up violence. They'll not just do that, but they'll also maybe call people names that might be racially motivated right. and things like that to try to start fights and create problems.
A lot of times try to turn people against the police officers there.
Right.
Well, also one of the problems is guess the Fed when you're mm-hmm. at large liberty-oriented events. This is a game that comes up is, hey, I wonder who the Fed is. Let's find the Fed. And this, people can be certain that they know who the bad guy is. And then if you advocate going around tackling them, you're going to, inevitably, probably very quickly, start tackling innocent people.
Well, whether you're right or wrong, whether you tackle the right person or the wrong person, you have created and you have aggressed against that person. The agent provocateur generally is not going to do the aggression. They're going to try to talk other people in the crowd into doing the aggression. They want to turn you into a target, a legitimate target, or what is perceived of as a legitimate target by the police who might be there observing. Pete, I'll let you go ahead real quick with a response. Go ahead.
But I'm talking about the kind of provocateur that'll tell you, okay, here's a coffee mug. I want you to throw it at this bank during Occupy and call the number and it'll explode. That's the kind you need to tackle. The ones until they commit a crime, you don't have a right to put them under citizen's arrest. But we need to start tackling these people.
When you say tackle, do you mean like a football tackle or like tackle him verbally? Well, you're completely out of your mind. Pete, thanks for the call tonight. I would not recommend anyone take Pete's advice ever whenever he's on the line with us, just for future reference. Everything Pete has said generally over the several phone calls he's now made over the last couple months have been terrible advice that will get anybody who takes the advice likely put in handcuffs, if not dead.
Yeah, I don't think I advocate for tackling, even in professional football.
I two-hand touch? Flag?
I think flag football is a better choice. It has just as much athletics. And I've got to say, when I watch football, I watch it for the athletics, and you can have the athletics without the tackling and for these guys being injured terribly. Mm. How does tackling really add to the game?
That's a great point. It really doesn't. Let's continue, though, with Frank in Raleigh, listening to Talk Radio 850. Hey, Frank.
Hi. I just discovered you folks. You're very refreshing. I'll chime in on the beef of the parking spaces. I've lived in owned my house in Raleigh for 30 years. It was built in 1949 and has been an ATM machine. And yet, when I want to go downtown and park my car, we've gone to a new system now where they you buy a little ticket and you put your number in. So, you know, you can't even get lucky and run across a meter that still has some time.
Yeah, you're right about that.
And it takes longer. Yeah. You know, if you could go up to the front of the meter that's in front of your car, plug a couple of coins in it, and walk off. And
now you got to go get a printout, bring the printout back to the car.
Every one of them's different, too. You have to figure out each one of the machines specifically to know how it works.
What number you're in,
Right. Those things. And you make a great point, Frank. These are called kiosks. Go ahead.
Well, I know. Well, what my plan is that you give everybody a free, say start out with 45 minutes. All right, that's free. Now you've got to move. If you don't move in 45 minutes, you get a ticket. All right. But if you get out before the 45 minutes and you cruise around and find another parking slot, then you get another 45 minutes. If you want to go downtown and run into a store or take care of some business, you can do it and do it quickly. And
there may be centralized plans that would be more efficient than what we currently have today, and that's what I'm hearing from you, Frank. But I think the best solution, from my perspective, is to allow parking spaces to be managed and owned by the business owners, to be owned and managed by the property owners in downtown. Let them all decide individually how to handle their own spaces. Maybe they want to have a time limit. Maybe they want to have a toll. Maybe they want to have a valet. I don't know. Let them decide. Let the market decide how to handle this.
Then you've got, but here, just roll back to square one. It's my money that is paid for those streets. It's my money that is paid for the sewage treatment plant. It comes out of my enormous property taxes every single cotton picking year. And yet every time the garbage truck comes by, and we've got an automated system now, we used to have it twice a week, now we've got it once a week. We used to have a bunch of guys that got an income and got a job. Now it's automated with the crane and the bucket and all that rubbish. My property taxes should pay for that, so the city owes me 1 hour a day, at least free parking downtown, and they cannot charge me for coming and picking up my garbage. Oh, and in Raleigh, it's ridiculous. If you live inside the Beltline, they have a special tax for that. Then you have an administrative fee for that. So for
it never ends,
water,
does it, Frank?
Thank you for
the call tonight, man. I do appreciate it.
The guys that drilled the well, then now they've got a well tax.
Good Lord. Thanks for the call, Frank. I appreciate the call.
A well tax. You're not on our sewer system, so we're going to need to tax you for that.
Yep, it's true. So share your thoughts, your observations, your stories here at Free Talk Live. The toll-free number is 855.
They'll tax your water. They'll tax your land. They'll tax your air. They'll tax your body. They'll tax your work. They'll tax anything that you'll let them tax. And then the vast majority of you that are listening to me will call up and defend their ability to tax those things.
It's true.
Yep.
It's true.
What was it? Harriet Tubman said, I freed 1,000 slaves. And I'd free 1,000 more if they knew they were slaves. We can look back and we can say that black people in Antebellum South, they were obviously slaves. But apparently Harriet Tubman, who had freed 1,000 of them, didn't think that they were.
Well, just to be clear, it wasn't obvious to all of them, right?
Like, yeah, I'm sorry. I kind of misstated that. But yeah, I mean, it wasn't obvious to all of them. That's all we're trying to do on Free Talk Live is to show you that organizations that claim a monopoly on you are not advocating for your freedom, cannot protect your freedom, not capable of doing it.
We'll come back with more. We got plenty of time. Got an entire hour to go here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Plenty of time for your calls and thoughts. You just dial on in here, 855-450-3733. And we still haven't talked about how apparently U.S. troops are somehow going to stop Ebola with guns. Or I don't know what other tool they have. Bombs, maybe? More on the way here. This is Free Talk Live.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Is gun ownership about target shooting, hunting, and self-defense, or is there more to it? Oath Keepers and Rayburn Entertainment present Molon Labe, inspired by the works of Edwin Vieira Jr., explains why we need to revitalize the state militia system. Featuring Ron Paul, Pat Buchanan, Larry Pratt, and Stuart Rhodes. Available on DVD at moviepubs.net, oathkeepers.org, and gunowners.org.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. Silver is trading at $18.71 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,237 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $473. Antiwar.com reports the Ukrainian government has offered a package of concessions to Eastern rebels aimed at ending the ongoing civil war in the nation, declaring a three-year special status for Eastern Oblast of Donetsk and Luhansk. The special status would grant the region increased autonomy, amnesty for the rebels, the right to use Russian as an official language, and the right to form local police forces independent of the national government. The three-year window, according to President Poroshenko, is meant to cover the period it will take before changes to the Constitution usher in profound decentralization of the entire nation, granting similar levels of autonomy to everyone. Over the weekend, Poroshenko confirmed the rebels released 73 Ukrainian troops as part of the ceasefire deal, though there are questions about whether the ceasefire would last.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports crews battled nearly a dozen major wildfires across California on Monday that have forced hundreds of people to flee, destroyed dozens of homes and structures, and charred thousands of acres of forest land left bone dry by the state's record drought. The most destructive of the 11 blazes, the Courtney Fire, quickly blackened 320 acres east of Yosemite after it erupted on Sunday, burning several homes to the ground, according to the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection. Some 1,000 people in and around the foothill community of Oakhurst and near Bass Lake were evacuated ahead of the flames, which were 20% contained by Monday morning as California baked in a heat wave that drove temperatures into triple digits. Further north, about 800 firefighters were battling a 3,900-acre blaze dubbed the King Fire, raging in heavy timber and steep terrain in El Dorado County. Nearly 250 homes were under a mandatory evacuation order, while residents of another 400 homes were advised they could voluntarily leave, according to the county sheriff. CAL FIRE reported one injury associated with the fire, which was 10% contained and spreading rapidly on Monday, but further details were not immediately available. Meanwhile, authorities near Los Angeles lifted an evacuation order as firefighters made headway against the 1,600-acre wildfire that forced hundreds of people to flee their homes as it swept through drought-stricken woods. This year's wildfire season, which typically runs from May to October, was on track to be the most destructive on record. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Time reports, a sweatshirt offered for sale by Urban Outfitters on the retailer's website caused outrage Monday as it seemed to market a bloody shirt from one of the most shocking episodes of the anti-Vietnam War movement. The sight of a faded vintage Kent State sweatshirt with red accents, which is no longer for sale, caused many people to notice that the marks on the fabric looked like blood. From there, the conclusion was simple. The sweatshirt seemed to be a reference to the May 4, 1970 Kent State shooting. The company said the resemblance was mere coincidence and issued a statement reading, "There is no blood on this shirt, nor has the item been altered in any way. The red stains are discolorations from the original shade of the shirt, and holes are from natural wear and fray. Urban Outfitters may not have intended to offend, and it does seem possible that nobody at the millennial-centric company even thought of, or perhaps ever heard of, a deadly protest that happened at Kent State more than four decades ago." This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
You're putting your name, address, credit card number, social security number, all that, you're just chucking it right up onto the internet where any disgusting degenerate can grab it? The only way to make sure that your identity is never stolen is to change it every 3 years. That's what I do. 2 years ago, I was Ellen Foxcroft, attorney at law. 3 years before that, I was Trish Homingwood, patient at the Austin State Psychiatric Hospital. And 3 years before that, I was Regina Dupree, lead singer of the soul group Derriere. And you know what? None of my identities has ever been stolen. So to make sure that your personal information stays safe, you gotta follow some simple steps. First, you're gonna need new pieces of identification, right? But don't worry, old Shelby knows a guy up in Detroit can fix these up pronto, real cheap. Next, you're gonna have to fake your own death. But all that takes is a mold of your teeth, a corpse, and a $500 used car for setting on fire.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into yet another hour of the program. You can bring up anything that you want, and the we tonight includes me, Ian.
Josie.
And Mark.
We got Josie Wales, a.k.a. The Outlaw. She's with us. She's got herself a Twitter, by the way. It's at Josie The Outlaw and the numeral 1, at Josie The Outlaw 1. Also, the same name is your channel on YouTube, also known as Josie Outlaw on YouTube. Get more of her there. And we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. We go to JD. He is on Skype. Our Skype username, by the way, is lrn.fm. JD, you're on Free Talk Live, calling from South Florida.
Hello.
Hey, JD. Go ahead.
Yeah, so going to the topic of things the state does and how a free society might deal with them, you asked Josie about this, and she said, you know, you can see, I mean, you can see a case made for roads fairly easily. Mm-hmm. And, you know, things like that. But I think the one thing that is quite tricky is armies and sort of country, in quotes, defense. And the thing that often comes up when this question is asked is that, yeah, private armies are a thing like Blackwater and all that. And yes, they are more efficient, but they are funded. Well, you know, they are hired by the government. So I don't know if that's a fair comparison. So I don't know. I'm just curious to see how you would solve that.
Just to be clear, is your question what would be done in the absence of a government, one-size-fits-all, monopoly military?
Right. Well, I mean, how would national, in quotes, national defense be dealt with in a free society?
Well, first of all, there would be no nation, number one, and so therefore there wouldn't
be. I don't know that that's the case. The fact is that this is the hardest question facing people who advocate for a free society. I'd like to make that clear right from the get-go. This is the toughest question because it's not that I don't believe that a government can rule that people can rule themselves sort of in a free fashion. It's that another place calling itself a nation or a state may very well try to attack and subjugate those people. And how would they defend themselves against a nation? Because it's one thing to defend yourself against a burglar. It's another thing, or maybe even a motorcycle gang, but it's another thing entirely to defend yourself against tanks and ICBMs and things like that.
But a free society, there wouldn't be a nation there, because a nation is an idea that is...
But there may be a nation attacking it.
Okay, I get what you're saying there. When you say that, you mean an army or whatever from some other plot of land. Nation is just a terrible idea that divides people all around the world and gets them to think that somehow because they were born on a piece of land in a certain, I like what Freedom Fiends were describing it as, in a certain GPS coordinates,
yeah,
that because you were born in certain GPS coordinates, you're better than people born in those other GPS coordinates. It's ridiculous. So if there were a plot of land that had true freedom, then hopefully the idea of the nation state would be gone, at least from that plot of land. So then what happens if somebody's going to attack? Well, the traditional mode of war is to attack the other nation, to attack their military, to attack their military bases, to attack the certain government targets. If there are no military bases, if there are no government targets to take over and to attack, then what will they do? What will the goals be of this supposed invasion? Is it going to be a house-to-house takeover? One neighborhood at a time? Things are going to get pretty tricky and difficult, especially when they're dealing with a bunch of armed people. I don't know about where you live down in South Florida. I remember there was some level of gun freedom in Florida when I lived there. Up here in New Hampshire, there's quite a bit of gun freedom, and in other places. So it's going to be a pretty tricky thing for them to attack 300 million people with 300 million firearms or whatever.
It's also really out of vogue, this whole army, this whole war of attainment, this attacking a country to get land. Yes, Russia's attempting to do it over in Crimea, but if you look into it a bit more, maybe what they're trying to do is take over land that's a majority of Russian citizens. I don't know the answer. Russian descendant types, nationalities. I don't know. I don't care. But I can tell you, Liechtenstein, Andorra, Belgium, Switzerland, Denmark, these are tiny little countries that are next to large countries that at any point could decide, you know what, we'd like that tax base, and they don't do it.
So what do you think, Josie the Outlaw? I mean, are you scared of this idea that the Red Chinese or the Russians or the Canadians are going to roll in here if we actually have some sort of freedom and try to take over?
That's never actually been a fear that I've had, but I have run into this. It is a tough discussion to have with people because it's one of the first things that, when you come across anyone, say an intelligent status, we'll put it that way, who thinks that way and who thinks, well, okay, what are we going to do when another country or another plot of land inside a certain set of GPS coordinates wants to set up a government here, or say we have natural resources in a certain area that they'd like to have and say they focus on that? Well, what's going to be there to protect that certain area? Let's just pick a certain arbitrary set of GPS coordinates like California. Let's say they have... Someone discovers gold again there. And, there is another army that wants to come in and grab that. What is going to be set up here to protect, that area? And when it comes down to it, if there is that free society, people will have the freedoms to defend themselves. And hopefully there will be...
They'll figure it out.
Yeah, privately contracted security companies. And
by the way, if those security companies... Or militias or whoever.
Exactly.
Whichever these groups are, they're not the government. They're not a monopoly. So they would be contracted in the case of a security company, which would mean that they would actually be obligated to defend your property. Whereas the military, if they're defending land, They're only primarily interested in defending government buildings and military installations. If they have to, if the military has to put a tank round or roll right on through your house, destroy your house in the mission of stopping the enemy, they're going to do that, and they're not going to cut you a check when all is said and done. It's just going to be part of the, you know, you got to break a few eggs and make an omelet. This is right. War. Sorry, you've lost your house. Too bad. Whereas if you are under contract with whatever protection agency would exist in the future, if they had to do damage to your property in the process of protecting your property, they probably would owe you for the damage that that was committed to your property. And there may even be insurance for things like that.
Right. And, you know, at night when I think about these crazy things, and, you know, I can't sleep, and it's so funny that this is what runs through my head, you know, now as I get older. But I think about how, you know, how awesome these private security companies are going to be. You look at some of the companies like, you know, Apple and those kind of, the, you know, technology companies that are out there. Well, I believe that the private security companies will be even bigger and more effective, and they'll have, you know, they could have little channels everywhere that then, you know, say one little area is affected or about to be or whatever, then, you know, a lot of people could respond, you know, that's, they'll take from where they need it and kind of put it that way. And I just kind of imagine all the possibilities on how amazing things really could
sure.
be.
Sure. What would competition and innovation in a free market bring to the world of defense?
Exactly.
I mean, we have it to some extent because there's private defense that you can hire today.
Right.
You can hire 24-hour security. You can hire bodyguards. You can do that kind of stuff.
Not to mention that there are more guns in the United States than there are people.
So yeah. We've just been going on here, JD. Do we address your question?
Yeah. That was pretty good. But I don't think it's just... I mean, you know, regarding the... There's no centralized power to take over of. That's true. But, I mean, what I'm thinking of is, say, you know, there's like a little ANCAP enclave somewhere, right?
Mm.
And that presumably used to belong to a country. I wouldn't put it past the state to just go and take over that again.
So you're talking about if, like, New Hampshire were to secede, is that the kind of enclave size you're talking about? Or are you just talking about, like, a neighborhood of people when you say an enclave?
Well, yeah, I mean, it could be a neighborhood. And that's the other thing, though, that when we think of a free society, we don't think of a state, but we definitely sometimes think about a system in which there would be maybe a company which people voluntarily pay to, and mm-hmm. that provides certain services. So you could still take over that. Now, I'm not, like, scared, and I don't think it's like a trump card against, you know, ANCAPistan or whatever. But
I'd rather take my chances. I mean, is there a chance that, let's say, New Hampshire secedes from the United States, that the United States or some other country would roll in tanks? I'd rather take my chances than live under what is becoming a tyranny where tanks are already in the streets in some cities.
But I don't think if New Hampshire secedes, it's going to do it based on a vote. And that vote is going to have people that vote against it. So therefore, mm-hmm. you're going to be forcing some people that don't want to leave the United States The United States.
Like, it's going
to
happen maybe in Scotland in what, next tomorrow, I think?
Yeah, but that's not...
In the next 24
they're
hours?
They're not going to be free. They're just getting themselves a new state.
There's still going to be some angry people who want to stay with the UK.
They are. They're indeed. No
so
doubt
are you
about
saying
it.
That the angry people are going to do something about it?
I don't know. Ian, I'm just saying.
We'll come back with more. JD, thanks for the call tonight. The toll-free number, you can explain it more here in a moment, Mark. 855-450-FREE. Yeah, I'd rather take my chances with freedom than live under a tyrant. It's Free Talk Live.
Powerful weight loss supplement is being given out to listeners in this area on a strict first-come, first-served basis. You must be between the ages of 25 and 65 and need to lose at least 30 pounds. Please call now only if you qualify. 1-800-409-5432. This product can cause dramatic weight loss, so supplies are limited. It's called Final Trim. Take two capsules just once a day as directed, and you can experience maximum weight loss. Pounds in days. It uses natural ingredients, making it healthy and safe. If your weight loss with Final Trim is too dramatic, please decrease use and only take one capsule a day. Call now and you will be given a full-size supply of Final Trim to use absolutely risk-free. Repeat, Final Trim is being given out to listeners on a strict first-come, first-served basis. Supplies are limited. Call 1-800-409-5432. 1-800-409-5432. That toll-free number again is 1-800-409-5432.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2237 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
35% of U.S. credit accounts are facing collection agencies. Of that 35, almost 40% are the result of medical bills. Before uninsured friends or family go in for medical treatment, send them to AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com. No computer tracing, no tracking cookies. They will not go on a list. Privacy matters. Just tell us what you need. Get a quote. Fractions of U.S. prices. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Mark, Bitcoin, the price, kind of on the low side right now. 470, 480, somewhere in there.
Somewhere in that ballpark, yeah.
Maybe a good time to buy if you've been thinking about getting into this amazing decentralized currency. Josie, are you into the Bitcoin?
I have some Bitcoin, yes.
Excellent. It's a fine idea to have some Bitcoin. You don't want to put all your money into Bitcoin. That would be putting all your eggs in one basket. That could be very dangerous. But I think that Bitcoin, like gold and silver, is a great alternative currency. In fact, of course, if you want gold and silver, you can go to gold.freetalklive.com. Those things, those have been around forever, and people know what they're all about. Bitcoin's a little bit new. It's kind of exciting, a little dangerous, a little scary for people, but also could be very, very good. In fact, yep. There are companies all around the world that are accepting Bitcoin more and more every single week.
I think it's a truism that good technology tends to drive out bad technology. Fiat currency, paper, flippy dollar things made by governments that are backed by nothing, those things are old technology.
Yes.
They've been doing that for some time, and what we find out is not only are they very counterfeitable and that the banks that store them are very beholden to the government, but at about every 40 years, they collapse and have to be rebuilt. Mm-hmm. And, you know, some collapses are minor and some collapses are major. You never know when one's going to happen. And, you know, they're just, you know, they're not a currency of value. Bitcoins are a much better technology when it comes to currency than fiat dollars are. And if you want to get into them, or other cryptocurrencies, you can go through expresscoin.com. They allow to get Bitcoin, Dogecoin, Litecoin, Blackcoin, Darkcoin in the United States or in Canada. You can do it by simply making a deposit at a credit union that has shared branching right in your town, and you'll have your cryptocurrency within a business day. That's pretty fast service. They're a licensed money services business. It's fast. It's safe. It's easy to use them. I've done lots and lots of business with ExpressCoin.com, and I'm going to continue doing it because they give great service. You can even do it from your smartphone by when you download the app from ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL on your first transaction. You can buy less than $40 worth of Bitcoin and pay no fee from ExpressCoin.com with coupon code FTL.
All right, let's continue here. You can bring up anything you'd like. Let's go to Nathan in Texas. Actually, we're going to go to Nathan here. He's via Skype, and you can join us via Skype at username lrn.fm. Nathan, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, Josie. Hey, everyone.
Hey.
Hello.
I thought it was interesting that Lysander Spooner seems to address a couple of both of the calls that came up earlier about, you know, whether or not it's aggression against, or whether or not aggression will be used against you if you don't pay your taxes. And then also the caller who talked about the Constitution, because Lysander Spooner both came up with this, this conclusion that if the Constitution has not been able to prevent the tyranny, then it's either been unable to prevent what we have or it has endorsed it. In either case, it's not fit to exist.
Mm-hmm.
And he actually, this is a lesser known thing that he said. He actually came up with something called the aggression principle, which is the idea that you probably heard every libertarian tell you at one point or another, which is that if you don't pay your taxes, a guy will come to your door with a clipboard. And if you tell him to go away, then a guy will come back and he'll have some cops with him. And if you tell them to go away, then maybe an armored truck will come back. And, you know, eventually things...
They didn't have armored trucks when Lysander Spooner was around. I don't believe you.
Okay. Well, he used the example of highwaymen, I think. It was men with guns. And
yes.
I think the essence of the principle is this escalation idea, is that and that's what the caller was arguing with somebody, and they said it themselves: if you don't pull over, they'll, you know, do a car chase down the highway. So the escalation itself, I think, is the essence of this principle, that if you refuse to comply, that puts the authority figure or the government worker or whoever you're dealing with in a position that's called a fork. They have to either choose to ignore your refusal to comply, in which case their authority is undermined, or they have to choose to escalate their use of force against you.
Absolutely true. Those are sort of the principles there, but that are I think a lot of civil disobedience is based on that. You know, when you engage in civil disobedience or non-cooperation with the state, that you put them in a difficult position where they have to choose to either crack down and look like little tyrants, or they have to ignore you and look like they're not enforcing their laws consistently. So either way, they lose the public relations game in that case, and the civil disobedient has to put up with whatever the punishment ultimately will be of that. But certainly the further that you push your disobedience, the more violent they will become. They will, unless they back away, like you're saying, they could back away. But generally, in my experience, they tend to continue to ratchet up the violence until they make their point.
I think that in many cases, they think Western civilization will crumble.
They've said things like that in courtrooms.
They do. They think Western civilization will crumble if they do not get compliance in this instance and every instance. And that, to me, I find fascinating. Is your system of governance so fragile that you must enforce your will every single instance? And let's not forget that this will is often enforced by the lowest level foot soldier in the state's army. People that in some communities, they have a limit on IQ for police officers. Most people do not consider the criminal justice degree to have been the biggest, most difficult degree to get. Oftentimes, you're not talking about our philosopher kings here enforcing the law. You're talking about minions, in movie parlance, stormtroopers.
And it's good. It's interesting you brought up the idea of minions, because that's actually what happened in the Kent State case. Is that you just had these basically recruits or whatever they were put in this position where they ended up shooting their weapons, and not only were they acquitted criminally, but like you're saying, it's like the fate of civilization depends on making sure they're not punished for what they did. You know, the civil case dragged on for 8 years. The financial settlement was paltry. There really just seems to be this idea that if, like, it's so fragile that if we even let the lowest foot soldier suffer the slightest amount of having to, you know, repay anyone for any wrongdoing, then the whole system will collapse.
Nathan, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Let's continue. Greg is in New York. You're on Free Talk Live. Greg.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Hey, you're on with Ian, Josie, and Mark. Go ahead.
Hey, guys. I called in last week, and I think towards the end of the week, the call kind of got derailed. I was talking about basically how to increase the liberty of everyone in society. And I kind of think that every time I bring up something, even if I can show evidence, strong evidence, that the outcome would be better, you guys say that it's stealing, it's forcing people at a point of a gun because taxation is theft. And I kind of wanted to
It's extortion is really
liberty.
What it is.
Yeah, yeah. It could be extortion.
And it's not okay to use extortion on people, even if you think the end game will be beneficial to them. It's just a moral position, and obviously you don't agree with it. You think it's totally okay to use extortion on people as long as you think it'll benefit them, right?
No, that's a straw man. I don't think it's okay to use extortion on people. I just don't think that taxation is extortion, and I just...
Well, how would you define taxation then? I'd love to hear that.
Well, that's what I'm calling in.
Great.
About.
Well, we'll find out what Greg thinks taxation is here. He doesn't think it's extortion. Is it a social contract? I don't know what he's going to say. We'll find out here in moments. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you'd like to talk to Greg. You can do that. 855-450-3733. What is taxation if it's not extortion? We'll find out. Free Talk Live.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait
a minute. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running?
Because you're scared of me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. Take control of the airwaves toll free right here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you care about privacy online, you need to know about ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network. They're also the sponsor of our phone lines here. And they encrypt your online data, meaning that before whatever you're doing, whatever website you're looking for, whatever search term you're entering gets to your internet service provider, it's encrypted. So your ISP is no longer able to snoop on you and maybe keep records of everything you're doing, which is probably what they're doing right now. And in some cases, they're keeping those records for up to 5 years. Now then, keep in mind, ProXPN is available for every operating system out there, at least so it seems. Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices, Linux users. Setup's a little different on Linux, but it works pretty well, and it's pretty simple to get started. Go and get their software at proxpn.com/FTL. You download that, you install it, and you get started for free. But when you're ready to upgrade to premium, you'll get special perks like unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can connect to, the ability to privately torrent, and even get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, it's all there with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN doesn't keep records of your online habits at all. So this is great privacy protection, and it's affordable. In fact, I'd say it's downright cheap. You can actually get it for 50% off their regular price of an annual account by using our discount code FTL50, that's FTL like Free Talk Live, and then the number 50. You can also pay with Bitcoin if you want to save even more. You'll save 62% off of the price of the annual account with code FTLBTC. In fact, we had a gentleman tweet something at us recently. His pleasure with using ProXPN, Dutch Blackwell on Twitter said earlier, I think it was yesterday, he said, I used your promo code, FTL50, also FTLBTC, with ProXPN. It's definitely worth it for the whole year. Easy to use. Definitely recommend, he says. He says he fully endorses this service. So check it out for yourself. ProXPN.com/FTL. Codes are FTL50 and FTLBTC. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's go back to Greg in Brooklyn. He's going to explain to us why it is he doesn't think taxes are extortion. And of course, when I use the term extortion, I mean the idea is you are threatened with violence to give people something that they otherwise didn't earn. Go ahead with your thoughts, Greg.
Sure. I mean, when people have a discussion, it's very easy to shut it down by demonizing the other person, let's say by saying, that's socialism, or, you know, somebody might say, that's wage slavery, or I'm pro-life, or I'm pro-choice. The thing is that you could talk about the substantive issues and talk about what, you know, how people are really affected. I'm, for example, a civil libertarian. I care deeply about personal freedom. And just when I think about economic systems, which economic systems would give the most people the most freedom, I don't think about a laissez-faire free market as being the best system for that. And so if you're saying that taxation reduces people's personal freedom, I am saying there are ways that it can actually increase it as a provable outcome.
Yeah, more money will make give people more choices, if that's what you're saying. And you could, go ahead and, for instance, what you've suggested in the show is give people sort of a minimum allowance from the government at any point. Then in the same breath, you call yourself a minarchist while suggesting the largest expansion of social welfare programs the country's ever seen, which to me is a flabbergasting statement to make. But,
Well, that would reduce the need. For example, that would completely eliminate the need minimum wage and a whole slew of other programs. Why would you need minimum wage
right.
if you're
by
already
creating the largest social welfare program the government has ever had? You might eliminate the need for some laws, but don't worry, the politicians will go ahead and fill in the gaps of the laws that they feel you need anyway. But what it really comes down to, Greg, this is what you've never been able to address, is that in order to get people to pay into your system, you must do one of two things. You must either create a system that is beneficial for business owners and entrepreneur types to create their businesses, or you must prevent them from leaving. And to some extent, the United States has done the former, but largely it has done the latter. What it has attempted to do is create a system across the planet of people being really unable to move from one country to another country. And you've suggested that you believe that people should be able to secede if that's what they want to do. So I should be
Absolutely.
Able to take my property and move it out of the United States into a magical geographical area I'll call Mark Edge Land. And then I wouldn't have to pay, the property taxes or whatever. But how are you going to forcibly extract money from people to pay for the government programs you want when people can opt out of the programs that you want to forcibly extract money for them for?
Well, first of all, I can say the same thing about your end goal and your system. Sure, you can secede to your magic land, but at the end of the day, that magic land will have to be run somehow. And you want private property, absolute private property, to be the way you run. So anywhere you are on that land, you will be on someone's private property, especially if you're an immigrant. And at that point, you are under their rule. So once again, you have to pay tax in the form of rent to someone. And it's the same system. It's just you're redistributing who is forcing you. In this case, it's the market that's creating market discipline. You have to work in order to survive, because once again, if you don't work, you're going to get kicked out by your landlord. And if you refuse the landlord, he's going to come with police. And if you refuse the police, you are going
you
to get
You are not
forced somehow.
To go and get an apartment. You're not forced to go and get a house. There may very well be, even in a system with private property, there may still be private property owners who open up their private property to the public. Like, for instance, there's the homeless place down in Florida. I'm spacing out it right now, but they take Bitcoin, for instance. Mark, you should be able to help me with this. The homeless place in Florida takes Bitcoin.
Oh, it's Satoshi Forest.
Satoshi Forest,
which is
Sean's outpost. Is the name of the group, and they let homeless people come and camp on their land, and they have no problem with it. So those people don't have to pay rent. No one's forcing them to do anything. So there are options out there in the world for somebody that doesn't want to go and be taxed by a landlord. Again, a tax is something that you generally don't consent to, whereas a landlord is something that you consented to when you got into the deal. But again, you haven't really explained to me how it is that it's not extortion. When you're taxed, you said you care about personal freedoms, but I don't hear that from you because you don't seem to care about my freedom from being threatened. I would like to have the freedom to not be threatened if I don't want to go along with your program.
What I am saying is, and I'll try to be very clear, even if you get the laissez-faire market completely without regulation, you will be not either you or a lot of people in that place will be threatened every day. Because if you think the freedom to be homeless or to accept the charity of a person is the ultimate freedom of these people, they could be a lot more free. They could do a lot more with their lives by actually educating themselves and being productive in society. And you're saying, well, it's too bad. You don't have any money. You have
That's
to depend
not what
on
I've
charity
said.
Of other people.
That's not what I've said. What's wrong with depending on other people for helping you out? I mean, there's nothing wrong with charity. Charity is a great thing.
I'm not saying anything's wrong with charity. What I'm saying is, in that system, a lot of people will be forced, because property is also enforced. They will be forced off the land of other people. They will be forced access to certain things will be denied because they simply don't have the resources, not even bitcoins. So at that point, what is a person to do? They're kind of stuck at that point, and they're dependent on charity. So, yeah, that's the same as people dependent on welfare. And how is that?
So you'd rather those people be, instead of being dependent on charity, the which is something that's based on voluntary actions by consenting adults and people who want to help each other, you'd rather those people get on some sort of government handout where everyone is forced by the threat of violence to pay for the people that they may not want to support.
No, no, I'm just saying that that system of property itself rests on the threat of violence. And everyone is enforcing their property rights and their payments and their rent using the threat of violence. So to answer your question, how is taxes—
It may not necessarily be the threat of violence, but I see what you're saying. You're saying that if you were squatting on someone's land, because you don't believe in property, yeah. Greg, if you were squatting on somebody's land, then at some point they might use force to get you off of that land, and that's what you're objecting to?
No, no, I believe in property. I just don't believe it trumps every other right. I don't think that – I think there are other rights and other protections that have to be balanced against property.
But you think rights come But you think rights come from a democratic decision, that you think as societies evolve, people develop more rights because they want more rights.
You don't believe in
property,
Greg.
I want a right to a Ferrari.
You don't even believe I own myself. Thanks for the call. More coming up here in moments. Plenty of time for your calls here. If you're on the line, we'll get to you next. This is Free Talk Live.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
If you're David, a few well-chosen words can help level the playing field with Goliath. I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com. Recently, I saw a Yellow Pages ad for an appliance repair company, and the headline read, "Why wait for Sears?" If you're going to the Yellow Pages, the Dead Sea Scrolls of advertising, you're ready to buy right now. So this is an attention-grabbing message. And how about the plumber whose radio ad says, "Call by noon Thursday, and we'll be there Saturday at no extra cost." Smart guy. Most plumbing firms give their crew the weekend off. This one gives them Sunday and Monday off. In the words of a respected advertising executive, "Cut to the chase, make it quick, and tell me exactly what you can do for me, especially if you're looking for work." For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. If you are already on the line, we're going to do our best to get you in. If you are not yet on the line, it is probably too late for you tonight. But we do the show 7 nights per week. So if you don't get in tonight, you can always call tomorrow right out the gate, 7 to 10 at night Eastern time. That's when we're live. So if you're not listening to us live on your local talk radio station or you're listening via podcast later on, you can still participate in the show by calling during our live hours and bringing up whatever you'd like to discuss. So the outlaw Josie Wales has been with us tonight. I'm glad you came in for the show.
Thanks.
A great way for listeners to get more of you on Twitter at Josie the Outlaw number one. Also Josie Outlaw channel on YouTube, and you're now part of Brutalist Media Productions on YouTube as well.
Yes, sir.
So more liberty-oriented media will be coming out of the Brutalist House, as it is called here in Keene, New Hampshire, which is right across the street here from the LRN.fm studios. As we continue with your calls and thoughts. Don't forget, you can join us and join Josie as well in real life at the upcoming Keenevention, October 31st through November 2nd. Josie, you're going to be hosting a brand new panel this year, Keenevention in its second year. Now we're going to have the New Movers panel.
Yay.
And I haven't talked to you yet about who you're going to have on. So I'm not asking you to broach that here. I don't know if you've nailed all that down. But you'll have probably 3 or 4 panelists plus yourself on stage. And they will all be people who have moved to New Hampshire within the last year, probably. And so we'll kind of get the fresh newbie perspective, the new blood perspective on some of the activism that's going on up here. What are we missing? You know, sometimes it's the new people that can come in and say, hey, we need to do this. You guys aren't doing this yet. Let's do that. So it should be interesting to see what you guys bring to the table. I'm excited about it. Keenevention is happening again October 31st through November 2nd. It's $60 for the entire weekend, which is an amazingly low price for a convention-style event. It'll be an intimate convention, and that means it's small. It's not a huge convention. It's in its second year, and it actually can't grow too much larger without it really overfilling the space that we have. It's being held in Keene, New Hampshire, not the biggest metro. We're probably in the largest hotel space in Keene, and with 100 people, it was comfortable. With 200 people, it would get pretty crowded. So I think it's always going to be kind of an intimate affair. And that's actually a cool thing because then you get to meet people. You get to meet everybody rather than just sort of randomly happening into people in an event with like 500 or 700 people.
Right.
So it's a totally different feel. And it's great, too, because we focus on activism. All of the speakers are going to be New Hampshire-based liberty activists. These are people who are the doers. These are the people with the boots on the ground. They're getting it done. These aren't the academics. I mean, there may be some academics among them, but these are the people who are the activists. And many of their names you've heard on this show. You can go to keenevention.info, and you can learn more. Get your tickets there. And by the way, it's $60 or the Bitcoin equivalent. So you can pay for your tickets with Bitcoin. And the hotel's a special price as well. So go check it out at keenevention.info. Let's go back to the phones and the fun. Frederick in Michigan, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Frederick.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Great show tonight.
Thanks.
I was going to present to Greg, the property tax enthusiast, to check out a fellow, the Corporation Nation, Richardson, who interviewed a brilliant lady I wish you would interview her. Tammy Peppermint. Tammy Peppermint. And if you go to the thecorporationnation.com, Clint interviewed her somewhere in, I think it was July. Oh, man. That'll make Greg's brain go through the center.
Why is that? Can you give me an executive summary of what this is all about? I'm not familiar with what you're talking about.
It has something to do with the fact that there have been court cases within the last 10 years, and tomorrow I'll call you back with the names of those, people actually went to court because they said property taxes, compelled performance, forced compliance, do this or else, is evidence of a presumed valid contract. And it just so happened, whenever I was going to ask Greg, is there any statutory act in any state? I found out in no state is there a statutory mandate to record your private land deed. That's because it would violate the Fifth Amendment. The very last sentence in the Fifth Amendment, private
this sounds like a conspiracy theory. Is this one of the legal conspiracies where you're saying that you don't have to pay property taxes if you just utter the right words at the county tax office or something like that?
I'm not saying that. No. I'm saying it's etched in stone that the state corporate government cannot violate their own charter, which says in the Fifth Amendment, the last sentence, go read it for yourself.
Without due private process property. Of law, not private property shall not be taken for public use without just compensation?
That's right. Public use means government use. And, okay, so you
how's
have
this
to
gonna
have
stop
a
my
of-
property taxes? I get what you're saying. There's no meeting of the mind, so there's no contract. It's invalid that there's no agreement to pay property taxes. Good luck convincing the tax bureaucrats of that and the judge.
Yeah, well, check out Tammy Peppermint.
All right. Thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it. It sounds like yet another scheme. There's all kinds of these people online, and I don't know if Tammy is one of them, but there's all kinds of people online who have the Set You Free plan. Just send them $500 via money order or cashier's check, and they will send you back a CD-ROM packed full of all of the secrets of how to escape from the system. Look, you've been snookered. You've been fooled. They've tricked you into these contracts that you didn't even know were there. They're called adhesion contracts, and da-da-da-da-da. It goes on and on and on, and it all sounds like it could be plausible. They cite the Constitution.
Well, the law's just a bunch of ramblings on a piece of paper, too, yeah. So, I mean, you know. Whatever.
Do you believe any of this stuff, Josie? You utter the magic words, and then all of a sudden the government, oh, crap, you figured it out. We thought we had the wool pulled over your eyes. All right, I guess you don't have to pay property taxes now.
No, I don't, because they don't. It's not like they're actually, not like the government's actually upholding the laws that they claim to uphold anyway.
They don't even follow their own rules.
They don't even follow their own rules. So what makes anyone believe they're going to follow rules that they forgot that they wrote somewhere along the way? It's along the same lines of the sovereign citizen thing. Mm-hmm. And, you don't have a person. You're not a person. You have a person. That's a whole nother one. All I know
there's no evidence it works. There's just none.
No, they're going to do what they want to do to encroach upon your freedom.
I'd like to put the challenge out there, though. I always like to throw this out there. Whenever somebody calls with one of these, please come to New Hampshire and go ahead. Take it easy. Go downtown. Maybe get a parking ticket or something low risk. Yeah. And then show us how you can get the government to respect your sovereignty through whatever court filings or, magic voodoo mumbo jumbo. Because I used to think this stuff was legit and I tried some of it and went down in flames. But of course, the people who advocate these things will always say, well, you didn't do it right. You didn't say these words in the right order. And so if I were there, I would have shown you how to do it. Well, come on up. Show us how to do it. We can get video cameras in the courtrooms here. So a lot of these people will also claim Some of them will be honest and they'll say they've never tried it. They've just done research. Right. Others will claim they've done it and they've been successful. So the next question I always ask is, well, do you have video? Do you have any audio of
Let's set the precedent. Here? Let's see you setting the precedent so that we can use that as a basis for
all. Right, come on up. Let's show the world how this actually works. I'm willing to go to the if you come up to New Hampshire and you get some sort of ticket or criminal charge and you can show us how to do this, I'll go into the courtroom. In fact, I'll be there myself on Thursday. And I'm constantly recording video in the court. I will absolutely pledge that if you're going to be in court in Keene, New Hampshire for one of these things where you're going to use some of these sovereign tactics, I'd love to record that and see how that works out for you. Let's continue here. We've got Dan in Southern California. Dan, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, hi, good evening. Hey. It's really great to see your show again. I've been absent for a while from it. And before I say anything, and I see I don't have much time, but
nope.
I wanted to make a request, and that is next time if you could move that huge mic so we can see the pretty face of your guest, in this case, Josie.
Another lurker is checking out the beautiful Josie Wales.
Yeah, your two handsome faces are always visible.
Well, the good news is
not nearly as interesting, are we?
Dan, the good news is Josie has her own YouTube channel, and there's usually no mic in front of your face.
Oh, I know. That's where I discovered her on her YouTube channel. But if you just move that mic, it doesn't take much work.
Okay.
Anyway.
Well, we can't do that. We'd like to hear Josie rather than look at Josie. I mean, not that you're bad to look at, but I'd rather hear what you have to say.
So that's an executive decision then to cover her. I can still see her eyes anyway.
Okay, Dan. That was a creepy way to end the show. thanks for the call. I appreciate hearing from you. Josie, it's been great.
I understand how he feels.
Yeah.
Who doesn't like to look at a pretty lady?
That's true.
No doubt. And Josie, I hope you'll come back another time.
Absolutely. I've had a blast. Yeah, thank
cool.
you.
All right, we'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, if you didn't get on the air tonight, no worries. Just call us back tomorrow at the beginning of the show. Everybody always loves to call in the last two segments. So we'll see you tomorrow. FreeTalkLive.com.
Are you Free Talk Live?
I don't believe in homosexuality.
Should homosexuality be outlawed, Rita?
I think not only homosexuality, but prostitution and fornication.
Fornication?
Are you going to pass laws against people masturbating?
I beg your pardon, sir.
Would you pass laws against people masturbating, ma'am?
I'm very much offended that you would ask me such
what, you
a question.
Can't answer
like
a simple question?
Would you pass a law against people masturbating?
Sir, I
mean, you want to pass laws against two men having sex. I'm just asking you a
question.
She said
she wanted to pass law against fornication. That's just anybody having sex.
That's anybody having sex.
Okay, Rita, let's say I have a fiancé and you overheard us having sex. Would you report us to the cops if there was a law against fornication?
You darn right, sir.
Yeah? How dare you?
How dare you?
Who do you think you are?
How dare you, sir? Who do you think you are?
How dare I have sex with a consenting adult
on my own property?
You're a moral reprobate, and you're one of the ones who are helping to disintegrate this country.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Peace News Now is next after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,237, silver opened at $18.68, while Bitcoin is trading around $470.97. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Well, Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free Script ASIC miner. Visit SovereignMiners.com to buy your miner today. And support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, President Barack Obama today is expected to announce a plan to send 3,000 U.S. military personnel to Africa to help with Ebola relief efforts. McClatchy reports that White House officials confirm President Obama's plan to launch a command center in Monrovia, Liberia, with 17 new Ebola treatment centers and the military personnel to help train healthcare workers. The plan also calls for the U.S. to provide sanitation kits to 400,000 households in Liberia. On Monday, Attorney General Eric Holder announced a strategy to disrupt homegrown terrorists from traveling to Syria and Iraq to join anti-American terror groups such as the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. Holder said the Department of Justice was partnering with the White House, the FBI, the Department of Homeland Security, and the National Counterterrorism Center to work with local community and religious leaders to help identify those who may join jihadist movements. As early as tomorrow, the U.S. House will vote on a resolution to approve President Obama's plan to arm and train Syrian rebels in an effort to stem the growth of the Islamic State. The resolution is expected to pass with bipartisan support. The language in the bill states that ground troops are not allowed and requires the Pentagon to report to Congress 15 days before the operation begins. Critics of the program fear the repercussions of the United States once again arming militant groups to fight off enemies. President Obama has taken much heat throughout his presidency for arming groups such as Al-Qaeda that the United States has labeled as terrorists. Support for Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, all-natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole. That's MyMagicMud.com. And today's edition of the Liberty Beat is also brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM, located in Austin, Texas, at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online, BraveNewBookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. The Miami Herald is reporting that a nurse who recently refused to participate in force-feeding Guantanamo detainees involved in a hunger strike will not face a court-martial. Navy Captain Maureen Pennington stated that he reviewed the investigation into the nurse and recommended that an administrative review take place to decide whether the official should be allowed to continue his Navy career. The decision to pursue an administrative review, as opposed to a court-martial, will allow the military to keep the details private. The nurse is a Navy lieutenant whose identity is currently unknown to the public. He apparently became a conscientious objector shortly before July 4th and refused to continue force-feeding detainees. NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden could possibly visit Switzerland in exchange for helping the Swiss government investigate U.S. spying on the nation. On Monday, the Swiss public prosecutor released a three-page document to Reuters detailing possibilities for a future visit by Snowden. The documents state if Snowden were to strike a deal with the Swiss government, he would be assured of free movement and would not be extradited. The documents are purely hypothetical, as Snowden has not been officially invited and was recently granted a three-year asylum in Russia. The Obama administration has responded to a petition on the White House website calling for body cameras to be worn by police officers around the nation. Roy Austin, a White House advisor on justice and urban affairs issues, said the technology was supported by the administration and the Department of Justice. Austin said cameras alone will not solve mistrust between the police and communities. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Now accepting Bitcoin online, rrbi.co, or by phone, 800-874-9760. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, September 16th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting.
According to a groundbreaking study on anxiety disorders published this week in the New England Journal of Medicine, researchers have discovered that feelings of anxiety can be completely resolved as long as people think about them real hard.
After studying subjects with mild to chronic anxiety disorders, we found that the best way to overcome mental stress is to isolate the root of the anxiety, analyze it from every possible angle, and then think about it nonstop until it completely disappears.
Researchers worked with numerous subjects in the middle of high-stress scenarios and said the key to overcoming anxiety is to start by focusing on a minor problem, list everything that can go wrong in the worst-case scenario, and then repeat that list in your head 200 times. After anywhere between 3 to 6 hours of perpetually torturing yourself over things outside of your control, all feelings of anxiety will completely disappear and you can finally enjoy the remainder of your day.
This is the Onion News Network.
Hello, everybody, and welcome. This is Peace News. I'm your host, Derek J. You can learn about me at derekj.me. You can also watch